Fans in the Bluefish win, you win. All fans in attendance for every Bluefish win. Here at Harbor Yard, we'll receive a coupon for a free item at all participating Wendy's. Please remember to be alert at all times for balls and bats that may leave the field of play. These items can be extremely dangerous. Please pay attention at all times for your own safety. The American Medical Response First Aid Station is located on the concourse down the left field line. Next to the information booth, please alert the nearest Bluefish staff member for assistance if necessary.
At Miller Lite, we believe if you're not choosing a light beer with more taste, you need to man up, not man down. Because up is way better than down. You don't tell someone sad to cheer down. What's down, dog? A steamy pile and you just stepped in it. Your girlfriend's not wearing a push-down bra. It's called gravity, Isaac Nitwit. Can I be down front with you? All this down talk is bringing me down. So don't man down, man up, and choose a light beer with more taste. Triple Hops Brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. At Miller Lite, we believe that sharing a pitcher of our great-tasting draft beer will bring friends together for a good time. And good is way better than bad. No one reminisces about the bad old days. If your guess is as bad as mine, then we're a couple of idiot faces. So far, so bad? Turn that frown upside down, grumpy pants. So why have a bad time when you could have a good time with a pitcher of Miller Lite draft beer? Triple Hops Brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. At Miller Lite, we believe if you're not choosing a light beer with more taste, you need to man up, not man down. Because up is way better than down. You don't tell someone sad to cheer down. What's down, dog? A steamy pile and you just stepped in it. Your girlfriend's not wearing a push-down bra. It's called gravity, Isaac Nitwit. Can I...
Yeah. the bed feels warmer, sleeping here alone. You know I dream in color and do the things I want. You think you got the best of me, think you've had the last laugh, bet you think that everything good is gone. Think you left me broken down, think that I'll come running back. Baby, you don't know me, cause you're dead wrong. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger. Stand a little taller, doesn't mean I'm lonely when I'm alone. What doesn't kill you makes a fighter. What steps even lighter, doesn't mean I'm over, cause you're gone. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger, stronger. Trust me, myself and I. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger. Stand a little taller, doesn't mean I'm lonely when I'm alone.
We welcome you to the ballpark at Harbor Yard. The Bridgeport Bluefish on a two-game winning streak, taking on the Lancaster Barnstormers in the finale. It's the first time that the Bluefish have an opportunity to win a series in quite some time. They had won four of their first five series of the year, going 12-5, but since that point, it has been anything but pleasant for the Bluefish, and perhaps they'll have their most difficult challenge of the series as they will take on longtime big leaguer and longtime AAA pitcher John Halama today. Harry Miles here. Raymar Diaz is going to the hill for the Bluefish against Mr. Halama. Diaz, in his last start, pitched seven innings of one run, no earned run baseball. And of late, the difference has been the starting pitchers and their ability to go deep into ball games, with the Bluefish offense coming up big in the process. 20 total innings from the last three starters, De La Vara, Serafini, and Oseguera. Four runs, only three of those were earned. They have been tremendous on the hill. They're hoping to get another performance out of Diaz similar to the ones that have been provided in the past. Diaz, a sinker slider type pitcher, will throw the changeup as well against Mr. Halama. Fastball, changeup, and curveball. He can reach anywhere from 83 to 86 miles per hour with the fastball. He is a similar pitcher to that of Corey Thurman, except from the left side. The Bluefish will have their hands full handling Halama today as the Bluefish and Barnstormers take place on this all-in family fun Sunday. Autograph session and kids run the bases. When we come back on the Bluefish broadcast, we're going to have starting lineups. We're going to go over a few changes that the Bluefish made today, and it's off to first pitch from the ballpark in Harbor Yard. You're listening to Perry Miles on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Don't check your wrist or follow up with your supervisor, because Miller Time has nothing to do with when and everything to do with who.
What's up, Tommy?
Miller Lite is brewed for the guys you're proud to call your brothers. We'll always talk you out of getting that faux hawk and never talk.
Nice.
During your backswing. And when you've got your brothers and the light beer that tastes like a beer should, it's not just a good time, it's Miller Time.
Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
Shark tooth, screwdriver, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, pork fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open the new Miller Lite Punch Top Can, but you'll always get the same thing. A smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together? Just like a good team. At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
This is Terry McGriff, pitching coach for the Bridgeport Bluefish, and you're listening to Perry Miles on the Bluefish Broadcast.
What a gorgeous day at the ballpark at Harbor Yard for a Bluefish baseball game today. Perry Miles here, the Bluefish taking on the Lancaster Barnstormers in the finale of a four-game series. And it all came down yesterday to not only the starting pitching of Paul Segura, the offense produced, and also the defense for Lancaster let them down. The Bluefish hoping for more success today. It's not a fireworks day, but plenty of fans will make their way out to the ballpark for first pitch from the ballpark at Harbor Yard on this Sunday, June the 17th. We want to wish everyone a happy and healthy Father's Day. I love you, Dad. And I'm sure many of the other players are about to say the same from the Bluefish and the Lancaster sides. The Bluefish and the Barnstormers having Father's Day game on this all-in family fun Sunday. Raymar Diaz goes to the hill. The right-hander had been struggling mightily at the mound before his last start when it appeared as if he not only dominated Camden, but also he seemed to be in a bit more control. His arm seems to be getting better and better almost every time out. At one point he reached 5 2/3 innings, but then had setbacks twice against Long Island and York one time. The Bluefish right-hander has not performed well in his starts. The team is 1-6 when he hits the mound. He is 1-5 overall. But that 7 innings of work may reflect what he might be able to do in the future. The Bluefish are hoping to get back the old Raymar Diaz, the one that won 10 games last year and lost just once. And the team was 10-3 collectively when he went to the mound as a starter. The Bluefish and the Barnstormers coming up. Let's take a look at the starting lineup after we go through John Halama's line. Out of Brooklyn, New York, another New York City product, a former big leaguer for the Seattle Mariners and a few others, including the Oakland Athletics. He was in the big leagues for a very long time. Seattle from 1999 through 2001 had double-figure victories in three straight seasons with Seattle. Two big league shutouts in his career at Texas and against Minnesota. And last pitched in the big leagues in 2006. He was with Oakland, he was with a few other teams, and the left-hander has performed very well this year. 4 wins and 3 losses, an ERA of 2.71. He is by definition a soft-tossing lefty. He is a crafty lefty at this point in his career, and even though he made it to affiliated baseball a season ago, made his way to ODP, opening day partners with the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs a couple of years ago, and then moved over to Butch Hobson on a trade, Halama for Adam Godwin, which Lancaster wound up with two players for the price of what turned out to be nothing. Lancaster's left-hander, 66 1/3 innings. He's allowed 64 hits, 15 walks, and 43 strikeouts. And he's yet to face the Bluefish this year. But the one daunting memory of the Bluefish was that he performs at this venue, Game 3 of the Atlantic League's Liberty Division Championship Series, and defeated the Bluefish by throwing scoreless baseball through a long period of time. I believe it was 7 innings of work of scoreless baseball as the Southern Maryland squad was able to push it to Game 4 of the championship series when the now retired Danny Putnam was able to come up as a hero for the team with a walk-off double in the 9th inning to send the crowd, to send the players into a frenzy. The left-hander Halama has lasted a minimum of 8 innings 3 times this year. He is an innings eater, and he is one of the better pitchers in the league, if not the best pitcher in the league. He is supported by this starting lineup. Adam Godwin is in center field leading off. Blake Galen is in left field batting second. Terry Tiffey is the third baseman batting third. Philot Lentini is the right fielder batting fourth. With that said, Tommy Everidge is still waiting for doctor's approval to be cleared due to the concussion that he suffered from an accidental elbow from James Simmons. Emerson Frostad is the first baseman batting fifth. Jaime Pedroza is the shortstop, batting sixth. Ryan Harvey, the designated hitter, bats seventh. And Brad Boyer gets an opportunity at second base. He bats eighth, so no Cody Kirkland from a day ago. Francisco Hernandez rounds out the rotation. He is doing the catching. And according to Dave Collins, the broadcaster for the Barnstormers, he was expected to be one of these big surprises of the Atlantic League, if not the biggest surprise, because of his ability to call the game, his ability to lead the pitching staff to success. The Bluefish will go with this starting lineup today, presented by BridgeportBluefish.com. Elliot Ayala gets an opportunity in the leadoff spot. He is the designated hitter. Last eight games, 14 hits in 34 ABs after starting off as slowly as he did. Eddie Rogers has been an influence in the lineup. He's been great in there. He is the shortstop, batting second. Prentice Redmond is the right fielder, batting third. Rock Peterson, who had a couple of base hits yesterday after going two for his previous 25, he bats fourth and plays first base. Luis Lopez, the third baseman, gets another crack at third. He bats fifth. Angel Flores is the catcher, batting sixth. More problems for Luis Rodriguez. He was hospitalized yesterday, and he is not expected to play today. The backup catcher, believe it or not, is one of the starters, and we'll get to that in a moment. James Simmons is the center fielder, batting seventh. The backup catcher for today is Peter Barrows. He's in left field, batting eighth. And Joe Pilecki rounds out the rotation, batting ninth and playing second base. Peter Barrows is the backup catcher for the team today. Luis Rodriguez was placed on the inactive list. Kyle Zaleski has been placed on the active list. He returns to the bullpen for today's action. The Bluefish will need a great start out of Raymar Diaz, and Lancaster is hoping to get the same from their left-handed starter. It's all been all about starting pitching in this series. The first game was a victory for Dwayne Pollock. The second set of games, the second and the third game, won by both Dan Serafini and Paul Segura. Will the same be the story today? We will find out right after the break on BridgeportBluefish.com when we return. Updated standings and first pitch.
We believe that sharing a pitcher of our great-tasting draft beer will bring friends together for a good time. And good is way better than bad. No one reminisces about the bad old days. If your guess is as bad as mine, then we're a couple of idiot faces. So far, so bad? Turn that frown upside down, Grumpy Pants. So why have a bad time when you could have a good time with a pitcher of Miller Lite draft beer? Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
I call this one best girlfriend ever. It had been a long day and an even longer week, so I headed toward the kitchen, refreshment I did seek. But after swinging open the fridge, I saw the most horrific sight. Not a single cold beverage, not a single Coors Light. I grabbed my keys, it was time to hit the store, but stopped when I heard a knock at the door. It was my girlfriend, bearing gifts of Coors Light. Best girlfriend ever? You got that right.
Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
Meet Ice Cube.
What's up?
Ice Cube is cold.
No, the coldest.
But one thing just might be colder.
Man, it better not be.
Coors Light has a new two-stage cold-activated label that not only tells you when your beer is cold, but super cold.
Yeah, I know, super cold. It threw snow on me last time.
It snowed on you?
You better check yourself.
Ice Cube is cold, but Coors Light is super cold. Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
Behind everything you're searching for is something you're actually looking for. When you flip through the real yellow pages for a plumber, you're actually looking to reclaim your home from a renegade faucet. It's not just getting directions to a tailor with YP.com. It's looking your best for an interview. And it's more than finding a mechanic with YP.com on your mobile. It's getting your road trip back on track. Whatever it might be, there are more ways to search and more ways to find exactly what you're looking for with the Real Yellow Pages, YP.com, and YP.com on your mobile, only from AT&T. Behind everything you're searching for is something you're actually looking for. When you search with the Real Yellow Pages, you get more than a contractor. You get a whole new curb appeal. It's not just getting directions to a dry cleaner with YP.com. It's rescuing an old favorite from the back of the closet. And it's more than finding a locksmith with YP.com on your mobile. It's getting to sleep in your own bed. Whatever it might be, there are more ways to search and more ways to find exactly what you're looking for with the Real Yellow Pages, YP.com, and YP.com on your mobile, only from AT&T.
A sizzling, succulent filet mignon, scrumptious salmon Florentine, savory twin grilled pork chops. Getting hungry? Your table awaits at the Park City Grill, Fairfield County's elegant new dining spot in the beautifully renovated Bridgeport Holiday Inn. Comfortable, warm, and inviting, Park City Grill offers a world-class dining experience at reasonable prices. Come to the Park City Grill, 1070 Main Street in the Bridgeport Holiday Inn. Take I-95 exit 27A to exit 2. Plenty of free, secure parking.
Baseball legend Henry Aaron reflects on his Hall of Fame legacy.
I think that since I played for the public, they need to share what I did in my life as far as baseball. It's the proudest moment of my life to give everything to the Hall of Fame. I often tell people they need to get and see it. There is no other building in the world like the Hall of Fame in baseball.
Celebrate the game. Celebrate the legacy. Connect with Cooperstown at baseballhall.org. Mike Piazza talks about the Baseball Hall of Fame.
It just connects you with the history of the game and the tradition of this game and how important this game is to the fabric of society. It's something I use to bond with my father, and I love to sort of teach my kids the history of baseball.
Preserving history, honoring excellence, connecting generations. Connect with Cooperstown at baseballhall.org.
We welcome you back to the pregame show on BridgeportBluefish.com. Perry Miles here. The Bluefish with a victory yesterday were able to make up ground on both Southern Maryland and Camden in standings. But the ultimate importance is for the Bluefish to catch the Long Island Ducks in the Liberty Division standings, because they would like to ultimately get an opportunity to get to the postseason without having to have their backs pinned against the wall. 21 games left in the first half of the regular season, with Bridgeport at 22-27, Southern Maryland and Camden at 24-25 each. Two games ahead of the Bluefish, Long Island seven games ahead with those 21 games remaining in play. The Lancaster Barnstormers at 29 wins and 20 losses on the year. They are 4.5 games ahead of the York Revolution. Somerset 23-26, and Sugarland at 20-28, as it appears that the Freedom Division might be getting closer and closer, with the Barnstormers hitting looking a little bit more human. Word does get around the league about the way that hitters' tendencies open up. There's much more scouting and many more people involved in the ball games as the umpiring crew makes its way to behind home plate to set up. Matt Beaver is behind home plate today. The first base umpire is Chase Edmondson, and Matt Hensel is over at third base. The Bluefish and the Barnstormers in the seventh game of the year between the two teams. Lancaster has won 4 out of the first 6 as a set of players makes their way to the home plate area. I believe Toby Stoner is one of them for the Bluefish, and it is number 27 Lance Burkhardt, who's not a hitter but a hitting coach, who introduces himself to Stoner at the batting area in the batting circle. And we are almost underway from the ballpark at Harbor Yard. There's going to be a slight amount of wind today, but it is an absolute gorgeous day. 75 degrees expected in Bridgeport. It will be much hotter down in the lower Susquehanna Valley when the Bluefish come to take on the Lancaster Barnstormers on the road for the 3 games that are expected to take place Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. And I'm sure the players will love that, especially the hitters, because some of the hitters have certainly struggled in this series. The Bluefish have done very well in this series to this point, having allowed just 2 runs yesterday after a solid performance the day before and even the day before. So the Bluefish pitching has certainly stepped up, and they're hoping for one more appearance in this series before a much-needed day off after playing 2 straight weeks of baseball, which included a 10-game homestand and also a mini road trip. The Bluefish and the Barnstormers coming up when we come back on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Have you heard about the clubhouse? Conveniently located in Fairfield, it has an unparalleled team of baseball and softball instructors offering private instruction camps, team training, rentals, and best of all, the chance to learn from an all-pro team, including Mike Porzio, former MLB pitcher, and the Bluefish's very own Willie Upshaw. Open 7 days a week. Stop in and meet our team, or call us 203-292-8700 and visit us at the web, theclubhouseCT.com, and get the Major League experience.
Behind everything you're searching for is something you're actually looking for. When you flip through the Real Yellow Pages for a plumber, you're actually looking to reclaim your home from a renegade faucet. It's not just getting directions to a tailor with YP.com. It's looking your best for an interview. And it's more than finding a mechanic with YP.com on your mobile. It's getting your road trip back on track. Whatever it might be, there are more ways to search and more ways to find exactly what you're looking for with the Real Yellow Pages, YP.com, and YP.com on your mobile, only from AT&T. Behind everything you're searching for is something you're actually looking for. When you search with the Real Yellow Pages, you get more than a contractor. You get a whole new curb appeal. It's not just getting directions to a dry cleaner with YP.com. It's rescuing an old favorite from the back of the closet. And it's more than finding a locksmith with YP.com on your mobile. It's getting to sleep in your own bed. Whatever it might be, there are more ways to search and more ways to find exactly what you're looking for with the Real Yellow Pages, YP.com, and YP.com on your mobile, only from AT&T.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise and remove your caps as we honor America with the singing of our national anthem being performed this afternoon by the International School at Dundee.
The national anthem performed for behind home plate. The Bluefish about to take on the Lancaster Barnstormers in the finale of the four-game series. The Bluefish hoping to win their first series since a while back in the month of May against the Camden River Sharks. That was 2 out of 3, which may have thrown the Bluefish in a little bit of a tailspin. A set of 10:35 and 11:05 first pitches during that week. Actually, Somerset was able to exploit the Bluefish offense and pitching. And each of the flaws have been exposed in the past, including Raymar Diaz, who heads to the hill for the first time in this series. Diaz this year, 8 games, 7 starts, 1 win and 5 losses with an ERA north of 9. Now, he's not pitched against the Barnstormers this year. He did not pitch last weekend against the ball club, but he is hoping for another solid performance the same way that he did on June the 11th. 7 innings, 1 run baseball, no earned runs on 6 hits. He picked up his first victory of the year, and for the first time he may have accelerated his confidence with his changeup, with his breaking ball, his fastball, his slider. He can feature all 4 pitches at any time, but he's most effective when he keeps the ball down and induces ground balls rather than strikeouts. More of a ground ball pitcher than anything else. There are a few pitchers in this league who are considered fly ball pitchers, Raymar Diaz, if he induces fly balls, those pitches are in all likelihood going to get torched. As Adam Godwin steps up to the plate, he's followed by Blake Galen and Terry Tiffey, 1, 2, and 3 in the order for the Barnstormers. Yesterday, Godwin came up with a couple of hits, scored a run, and drove in a run. He has been a beast to handle for the Bluefish. Entering a couple days ago, 9-for-19 against the Fish. He came up with 3 hits since that point. We will see what he's able to do with that at this stage, as the first pitch is on its way from Raymar Diaz. He releases his first pitches outside. We are underway. 1-ball, no strikes. 2:09 Eastern, first pitch, and it is about 75 degrees at the ballpark. A beautiful day, very few clouds. The 1-0 fastball scales outside. 2-balls and no strikes. Godwin of the year, 365. He is a speed demon. He can fly like the wind. And one player that's going to have to deal with him is Luis Lopez. Godwin has shown bunt a decent amount in this series. As the next pitch rotates away, 3-balls and no strikes. Eddie Rogers is over at short. Joe Pilecki gets another opportunity at second base while Pedro Lopez is rehabbing his sore hand. Brock Peterson is over at first. The catcher today is Angel Flores. The 3-0 outside ball 4. Adam Godwin draws a leadoff walk on 4 pitches, and that is not good news brewing for Diaz as Blake Galen steps up to the plate. Flores replacing Rodriguez. Rodriguez had to go to the hospital for an unknown reason, and we do not know what his return will be. All we know is that Flores is the catcher. The backup catcher would be Peter Barrows on the team. Barrows is in left field. James Simmons is in center. Prentice Redmond occupies right. That is your defensive combination for the Bluefish today. The throw to first is not in time. Adam Godwin not only is a stolen base threat, but he has done so against the Bluefish and against some of the better pitchers on the Bluefish squad. Luis Rodriguez has said repeatedly that it's all about the rhythm, that it's really how many seconds that you get the ball to the plate. As a throw to first nearly got Godwin on the swipe. Laura is trying to emphasize that early with a set of signals, because pitchers on occasion have taken anywhere between about 2 seconds and 2.5 seconds to get to the plate, and that results in stolen base opportunities and stolen base successes for the Barnstormers. You have to worry about Adam Godwin, Blake Galen, and Philant Lentini especially. It's not to say that the others won't do it, but Galen is one of those fast guys, and so is Godwin, as he takes a decent-sized lead over first. Another throw to first as Peterson has to go in a catcher squat to make the play. And Godwin is back there. Godwin with 16 stolen bases. He's been caught 5 times. Galen on the year at 308. 9 home runs tied for the team lead. The next pitch, fastball, cruises to the outside corner. No balls and 1 strike. All those throwovers by Raymar Diaz helped him to keep the base runner at first, and they would not like Godwin to move anywhere from there. Double play ball would be nice. The middle infield playing 3/4 of the way back, hoping for that turn. 0-1, Diaz steps off the rubber again. Whenever the leadoff batter gets on with a decent amount of speed, it behooves the pitcher to alter his rhythm. He threw over so many times, then he stepped off after the first pitch was released. The second one, a slide step, lines up with the outside corner. No balls and 2 strikes on a heater. Left fielder Peter Barrows is playing very deep, understanding that Galen has tremendous power to the opposite field. In the last series against the Bluefish, he hit one down the line, and he also hit one toward left center field over the wall. Down the line, meaning the right field line. The 0-2, fastball away, 1-ball and 2 strikes. Willie Upshaw continues to emphasize about command. It is one of the more important elements to pitching. If you are able to establish a pitch 3 to 6 inches off the corner and then rotate it back inside, you might confuse the batter. It's all about changing eye level and changing speeds. Setup is outside one more time. Diaz waits, the slide step pitch. Fastball just a little high, maybe a tad outside. 2 balls and 2 strikes. No score from the ballpark at Harbor Yard. Runner at first base, nobody out. Adam Godwin walked on four pitches, but it seems that Raymar Diaz has gotten into a little bit of a rhythm with Galen at the dish. Flores establishes inside initially before a throw goes to first to check on Godwin. That's what really needs to happen. They know that Godwin is a threat to go. Second on the team in stolen bases with 16. Lentini, who set the franchise record with 17 consecutive steals without getting caught. He's batting in the cleanup hole today. The pitch is lifted foul down the left field line. A slap attempt by Galen. Two balls and two strikes. It's all about the outfielders providing that speed. Usually the middle infielders possess some of that speed as well. Not reflected on the way that Lancaster runs the bases. Two balls, two strikes from Diaz. Hold still, pitch on its way, slap foul down the left field line. Excellent location from Diaz. All Galen could do was spoil it. Appeared to be about 2-3 inches off the corner. Galen thought it might be going in there. Professional hitters know how to fight those pitches off. Engage in battles. Two balls, two strikes. Diaz stares in, gets the signal, and brings the ball up to his glove about shoulder length before the 2-2 throw to first is not in time. The Bluefish were not the only ones in action yesterday, with Paul Segura picking up his fourth victory and the third loss from Brockman. Southern Maryland suffered a loss 2-1 to the Long Island Ducks. John Malone picked up the victory. He's now 4-0. Chris Mobley, who was on the inactive list for quite some time, took the loss. He's 1-1. The 2-2, slap down the left field line, foul. Two balls, two strikes. Brian Nelson with the only RBI. Run scored from Navarrete and McGowan. Navarrete, Esquivel, and Singh with multiple hit days. RBI from Espinoza. Virgil Vasquez, a.k.a. Matt Vasquez, 6 innings, no earned run baseball. Bob Zimmerman, 8 innings of one run baseball. Long Island winds up winning that game in what turned out to be a major pitcher's duel. The 2-2 swung on and stroked in the air towards left center. James Simmons drifts in front of the Budweiser sign, makes the play about 30 feet in front of the track for the first out of the ball game. Godwin returns to first. It was a tough battle by Galen. Now it's Terry Tiffey that's determined to ruin Diaz. Third baseman, a former Minnesota Twin, given a number of opportunities in the big leagues, and was quite successful for a period of time. A single yesterday's game. And in this series, he's picked up two hits, and he's driven in one run, two runs. RBI infield single in the eighth inning. One yesterday, one in the opener, with Lancaster winning the opening game of this series. First pitch on its way from Diaz to Tiffey. Fastball high, one ball and no strikes. Plenty of history on Tiffey. Lancaster picked up his services a year ago. There are a number of players that went to affiliated baseball, which allowed Tiffey to get on the squad. And now he hangs out with an open stance. Diaz waits, Godwin taking a lead, and more concern shown from Raymar. One ball, no strikes, one man out. Top of the first inning. Diaz waiting. He's set at the shoulder top. Next toss, fastball away. Two balls, no strikes. Tiffey's been a professional since 2000. Made his major league debut September the 1st of 2004. Was with the Minnesota Twins for 2005-2006. Spent a decent amount of time in 05. And then had an opportunity with the Dodgers. Really was never given that chance afterwards. Last year hung out mostly with Scranton Wilkes-Barre, the Yankees organization, as the pitch is outside. Three balls, no strikes. Two other players made it to the Yankees last year in their affiliated ball club. Rene Rivera was one of them. And then the other one, of course, was Logan Kensing for the Bluefish. Tenzing's rights were retained by Sugarland after the Bridgeport squad did not hang on to him. The 3-0 is upstairs, ball four. Tiffy takes his base with a one-out walk. Back two walks so far. Godwin moves over to second base. With one out, it brings up Villalentini. Right fielder had 5 RBI in the first two matchups against the Bluefish, but then has struggled to drive in runs. Yesterday, he was batting second in the lineup. He came up with a base hit. He was 1-for-4. Meeting of the minds of the mound. And it appears that Dan Serafini made his way out there to talk with starting pitcher Raymar Diaz and jogs back to the dugout to make sure that Diaz is calm. It's all about confidence with the starting pitchers. Last year with Lancaster,
right there, number 20,
Tiffy did not walk a whole lot. 14 walks and 198 at-bats. And then with Wilkes-Barre Scranton, had a few home runs as well as Lentini delivered inside. 1 ball and no strikes. Right fielder's been tremendous. Can hit the ball for power, can hit the ball on the ground with great velocity. The second baseman, Joe Pilecki, leaning towards second as he baits. The next pitch is inside. 6 straight pitches out of the zone. And it's been all over the place for Diaz. Against Tiffy, his deliveries landed high. Against Lentini, everything has been low. Bluefish right-hander hoping not to land one right between the two. The 2-0, swung on and missed, big cut. 2 balls and 1 strike. The Barnstormers have had their opportunities to hit with runners in scoring position. It's not been a fruitful endeavor for them. If you look at the way that they've hit with runners in scoring position, 255 as a unit. Bridgeport on the year at 297. The 2-1 swung on, a jam shot sent towards left field. Peter Barrow's charging in and makes the play. He was playing deep, but he made off a ton of ground. He has long strides, almost the way that an Olympic runner has, and use those long strides to gain ground and make the play. It's an F7 on your score sheet. Two-way brings up Emerson Frostad. Frostad this year batting 276 with runners in scoring position. And Lantini not quite getting the job done except against the Bluefish early on in his set of appearances against the team from the Park City. The 2-out toss from Diaz, fastball right down the middle, 0-1. If Diaz has this inning where he struggles, he gives up a couple of base runners due to walks, but then regains that command that he had his last start, he'll be in great shape. Sometimes pitchers struggle in the first inning because they're trying to get a feel for the strike zone, a feel for the game. The 0-1, fastball outside, may have been a tad high, 1 ball and 1 strike. It does not translate at times from the bullpen to the regular mound. A different feel, a different rhythm, and of course there's a batter in the box, which is different than when there is none, when the pitcher warms up. The throw to home plate is not made. Timeout is called. Flores and Diaz must communicate. In all likelihood, they will speak in Spanish, make sure that everything is communicated appropriately. Both speak English fluently. Diaz, part of Puerto Rico, he learned how to speak English very well, and Flores speaks fluent English as well. They can speak in either language, but they make sure to hold the glove up to make sure no communication is intercepted by reading lips. The 1-1, fastball delivered inside, 2 balls and a strike. Emerson Frosted on the year at 330. Just been ridiculous in his limited at-bats compared with the rest of the teams at 100 AB so far. Adam Godwin has had the most, and most leadoff hitters do. Kennard Jones is the most at-bats for the Fish this year. Diaz is 2-1. Runner goes, pitches swung and missed. The throw to third is not in time as Godwin swipes third. The only element of the game that's changed because of the stolen base is that if Diaz throws a wild pitch or if there's a pass ball or if there's an error on the infield, that Godwin would be able to score. Otherwise, a walk doesn't do it. A single will do it anyway, even with two men out. Godwin can fly. Scouting report indicates that a great contact hitter drives in some runs from the leadoff spot. The 2-2. Swung on and foul tipped. It popped in and out of the glove of Flores to stay alive. Two balls, two strikes. Just missed that ball. Once again, a happy Father's Day to everybody out there who's celebrating. Many of the fans making their way to the ballpark today. It is a late arriving crowd. The Bluefish fans have shown up though today. Two balls, two strikes, two men out. Diaz delivery, swung on and fouled to the backstop. For Diaz not to have allowed a run and to have thrown as many pitches as he has, he needs an effective second inning in order to reduce his pitch count so that way he can last longer into the contest. We will wait and find out what the results of Frostad are in just a moment. Two balls, two strikes, two men out. Diaz releases, swung on and driven high in the air to the right of center, playable for James Simmons. He stops and makes the play for the final out of the inning. A long frame for Diaz, but he does not give up a run. No hits, two runners left on. End of a half. No score from the ballpark at Harbor Yard. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on the Bluefish Broadcast Network.
At Miller Lite, we believe that sharing a pitcher of our great-tasting draft beer will bring friends together for a good time. And good is way better than bad. No one reminisces about the bad old days. If your guess is as bad as mine, then we're a couple of idiot faces. So far, so bad? Turn that frown upside down, Grumpy Pants. So why have a bad time when you could have a good time with a pitcher of Miller Lite draft beer? Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Shark tooth, screwdriver, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open the new Miller Lite Punch Top Can, but you'll always get the same thing. A smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together? Just like a good team. At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
This is Terry McGriff, pitching coach for the Bridgeport Bluefish, and you listen to Perry Miles on the Bluefish broadcast.
27 pitches thrown by Raymar Diaz in inning one as he was able to escape the jam unscathed. Two walks in the inning. No score heading to the bottom of the first with Elliot Ayala taking on John Halama. so many stories about John Halama and the fact that he was in big league baseball for a long time. He's been in Atlantic League for quite a while as well, the elite independent league in the United States. The first pitch lands low, one ball and no strikes. He's been a professional for quite a while, since the early 90s, almost the way that Luis Rodriguez has been, as the pitch is outside. Two balls and no strikes. 1994 was his first minor league season. Bishop Ford Central Catholic High School in Brooklyn, the 2-0, fastball away, three balls and no strikes. April 2nd, 1998, his major league debut with the Houston Astros. Went to the Seattle Mariners, performed very well, and then went to Oakland, Tampa Bay, Boston, Washington, Baltimore, as the pitch is out of the strike zone, outside, ball four. Halama gives up a leadoff walk to Ayala. Halama is accustomed to pitching in big spots. He has pitched in Major League's postseason with the Mariners. The 2001 season was a great year for Seattle, as were the years before that, after Ken Griffey Jr.'s departure in 1995. That Seattle team was loaded with talent, and Ichiro Suzuki was one of the few pieces remaining from those squads earlier. 2002, 2003, the first pitch from Halama is a fastball in the outside corner, no balls and one strike. To think that Ichiro was really, really a rookie maybe more than a decade ago is interesting in itself. He's pitching the Major League Baseball postseason. He's pitching the Atlantic League postseason. So much experience from Halama. And last year, 6 wins and 6 losses in ERA, north of 5 with Lancaster. The 0-1 stroked high in the air towards left center field. Galen on the move. He dives and makes the backhanded play. He gets up and flings it towards first, but it has to be cut off about a quarter of the way from first base towards home plate in the grass area. Eddie Rogers lines out to left field. Blake Galen, Adam Godwin, Vilant Lentini from left to right in the outfield. Terry Tiffey, Jaime Pedroza, Brad Boyer, Emerson Frostad from left to right on the infield. Francisco Hernandez is the battery main for Mr. Halama as Prentice Redmond moves forward. He's been in the Atlantic League from 2007 through 2011. He's been part of three different teams, Lancaster, Southern Maryland, and before that it was Long Island in 2007. The one out tosses over the middle. No balls and one strike. He pitched very well in 08 with the Blue Crabs, which earned him a trip to AAA Buffalo, part of the Cleveland organization back then before they switched affiliates. Buffalo, now the New York Mets affiliate in AAA. The 0-1, fastball low, partially blocked by Hernandez as he scampers to his left to prevent Ayala from moving to second base. Ayala in the past has been a stolen base threat. This year has been caught a few times. He's yet to steal successfully, except against the ball clubs when he was with Somerset. He's been caught twice. On the base pass, he takes a modest lead. The next toss, low, one ball and one strike. Ayala has been raking his last 8 games, which is why he's gotten on base so often. And he's also driven in as many as 4 runs in a game. This season, yesterday, he drove in 2. But he's standing at first with Redmond at the dish, the 2-1. Fastball low, 3 balls and 1 strike. When both Redmond and Peterson were struggling, it was very difficult for the Bluefish to push across some runs. But over the last few games, Redmond has begun to turn it around, and so has Brock, especially with his performance yesterday, picking up a couple of hits. And a number of players drove in multiple runs yesterday. The runner goes, the 3-1 is grounded towards third. Tiffey handles, looks at second for a moment, but decides to go to first. And delivers the 5-3 strike to eliminate Redmond. 2-away. And it brings up Elliot Ayala. Or rather, Brock Peterson. Apologize, Brock Peterson. Peterson, the first baseman, had a stretch of 8 games in out of 9 where he drove a ball out of the ball yard. He had gone 2 for his next 25. But yesterday, he seemed to have turned around. He worked a little bit with Willie Upshaw. There were rumblings suggesting that he may get picked up, and those rumors turned out to be half true, half false, as the pitch is right on the outside corner. No balls and one strike. Peterson had the opportunity, but he's going to wait a little while longer. There were rumblings about that. He did not decide to pick up the offer. And so he'll be a member of the Bluefish until someone does decide to pick him up. And if he continues to stroke the ball, there are a number of people from different organizations that feel that his numbers at first base project to the AAA level. And he had an opportunity to go to the big leagues as well in spring training. No balls, one strike, two men out. The next toss from Halama, swung on it, foul tipped at the plate. No balls, two strikes. Halama throws a very slow curveball. He can even throw one of those Ephus pitches, which is even slower than a curveball. The equivalent of a lob, almost. Halama waits. No balls, two strikes. Pins the glove against his chest, brings it down to the belt. Southpaw twists his head back and forth before he delivers. Pitch right on the inside corner, strike three. Peterson could not believe it as he flings his bat towards the first base side and his helmet in frustration. There was one base runner in the inning, but that base runner did not score. No hits. At the end of one, no score from Bridgeport. You're listening to Perry Miles on BridgeportBluefish.com. We'll be right back.
We believe that sharing a pitcher of our great-tasting draft beer will bring friends together for a good time. And good is way better than bad. No one reminisces about the bad old days. If your guess is as bad as mine, then we're a couple of idiot faces. So far, so bad? Turn that frown upside down, Grumpy Pants. So why have a bad time when you could have a good time with a pitcher of Miller Lite draft beer? Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. At Miller Lite, we believe if you're not choosing a light beer with more taste, you need to man up, not man down. Because up is way better than down. You don't tell someone sad to cheer down. What's down, dog? A steamy pile and you just stepped in it. Your girlfriend's not wearing a push-down bra. It's called gravity, Isaac Nitwit. Can I be down front with you? All this down talk is bringing me down. So don't man down, man up, and choose a light beer with more taste. Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. At Miller Lite, we know there's only one thing baseball fans love as much as great Pilsner taste, and that's rooting for the home team. Because home is way better than away. Away is not where the heart is. Bringing away the bacon? Why? Bacon is delicious. Away is where you hang your hat? You should be hung up by your underpanties. So why root for the away team when you can root for the home team? With a great Pilsner taste of Miller Lite. Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Shark tooth. Screwdriver. Golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on. Grill fork. Tuning fork. Fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle-nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open the new Miller Lite Punch Top Can, but you'll always get the same thing. A smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. Shark tooth, screwdriver, skeleton key.
Bluefish baseball is back on the air. Perry Miles here. The first pitch was on the inside and foul tip. The next toss is on its way from Raymar Diaz. Fastball outside to the top of the second inning. One ball and one strike. Jaime Pedroza, the shortstop, has shown great range to this point at that position, but really has not flourished on the offensive side. Has had one hit, a couple of walks over the last few games. The next toss is outside. Two balls and one strike. Bluefish will see the Barnstormers again on Tuesday. J.D. Durbin against Toby Stoner in game one of that set, followed by some similar pitchers to the way that the Bluefish have seen. The next toss is foul, tipped into the glove. Two balls and two strikes. Gilbert De La Vara against Dwayne Pollock, which is a rematch of this past week. Followed by Dan Serafini and Alan Johnson one more time. Johnson appears to be okay after having a couple of back issues that he had to fight off during his last start. The 2-2 is foul tipped into the glove for strike three. Raymar Diaz eliminates Pedroza quickly after a 27-pitch first inning. One away brings up Ryan Harvey. Harvey is a large, tall man. And there were a number of scouts who were thinking, this guy's going to hit 30 home runs. Baseball Cube says that his power was indicated at a 90. Well, certainly has the pop. He showed it yesterday. The difference is the ball really did not carry. The first pitch is on the inside corner. No balls and one strike. The ballpark at Harbor Yard is either the most difficult place to hit a ball out of the yard in or the second most difficult behind Constellation Field, which I've been told has larger dimensions than this ballpark. The 0-1 twists inside, one ball and one strike. It's not to say that there are ballparks in the big leagues that are smaller, or for that matter, ballparks in the big leagues that might be larger, but Constellation Field, from what I hear, is 348 down the left field line, which the majority of right-handed batters would be trying to aim for. The 1-1 is dribbled towards third, handled by Lopez. He squares and delivers a toss, and it could not be scooped up by Brock Peterson. Another short throw by Lopez. He commits an error. Peterson could not grab it out of the dirt. It is an E5, allowing Harvey to reach. It was a difficult play for Lopez initially to get the ball, but once he got the ball, the throw should have been second nature. He understands that. It's Brad Boyer comes to the plate.
Second baseman, number 7, Brad Boyer.
Boyer, the second baseman, had to replace Everidge due to that concussion in the batting order, not necessarily in position. Boyer played second base during that day, and Tiffy played first. Last couple of days, it's been Emerson Frostad occupying that spot because that's one of the positions that he came up with in the Texas Rangers organization. The first pitch is planted on the outside corner. No balls and one strike. Frostad loves catching, but he came up as a corner infielder. He could drive the ball quite well. This lineup, he's hitting fifth today after batting low in the order in game one. Moving up, the 0-1. Taken outside. Boyer ahead. Now evens the count at one ball, one strike. Bluefish baseball on the Bluefish Broadcast Network. The Bluefish at 22-27 have won two consecutive games. Bridgeport has not won three games in a row in a long time. The next toss is inside. Two balls and a strike. Last time that the squad won three games in a row, you'd have to go all the way back to May the 1st through May the 5th, when they were in the middle of a five-game winning streak, which included Long Island and York. Really never built up too much of a winning streak this year other than that five-gamer that spanned from those dates. The 2-1 is directed outside, three balls and a strike. And the most number of games that the team has won since that point is two in a row. They had really struggled with five consecutive losses, a series of four-game losing streaks. Just been a nightmare for much of the time for the Bluefish as they hope to get their pitching straightened out. So far, 21 innings of four-run baseball in this series from the starters. The pitch is outside, ball four. Boyer draws a walk. Runners at first and second for Francisco Hernandez. The Bluefish saw what Lancaster's defense did last night. Four of the nine runs allowed by starter Brockman wound up being unearned as Dan Serafini jogs to the mound to discuss matters even more with Diaz, facing a similar situation to the one that he faced in the first inning. He's given up three walks and no hits. And another runner has reached base due to an E5. Do not know what Serafini is talking about other than maybe to calm down the pitcher. Serafini's been there in the big leagues for quite a while. Makes a jog back to the dugout to make sure that players feel comfortable out there. He makes takes a seat and is watching from there as Willie Upshaw hopes to cheer for his pitchers. He continues to watch what Diaz and Flores are trying to develop. The one-out toss lifted high in the air, foul, opposite field approach. Hernandez, one strike to him. It is his first at-bat of the game. Hernandez, one of the guys that may be one of the better catchers by the time the year ends, at a double three-run home run on May the 12th, and he's been hitting very well of late. Last 12 games, 13 hits and 36 ABs. The 0-1 from Diaz. Righty-lefty situation. Diaz sets it up chest high. The 0-1. Line drive, base hit to right field. Butch Hobson waving around, and Hobson cuts off his base runner to hold as a nice throw was made by Prentice Redmond to Brock Peterson, who is cutting the ball off in line with home plate. The bases are loaded with one man out to bring up Adam Godwin. And what a situation for Diaz to be involved with.
Number 41, Adam Godwin.
He tangled himself in what seems to be a spider web of runners. He's just trying to find a way out. Godwin hoping to take a grip in this at bat. He walked in the first. Diaz waits. He's set. Elbows down. No one out toss. Off speed pitch on the inside corner. No balls and one strike. No balls, one strike. The runner at third base, Ryan Harvey. Brad Boyer's at second, Hernandez at first. Diaz delivers, and the pitch is swung on and foul tipped. No balls in, two strikes. Bridgeport hoping for the double play. Up the middle, they're playing about three-quarters of the way back. Luis Lopez, Brock Peterson playing off the first and third base and first base backs, respectively, as Diaz stares in for the sign and gets it. Setup is outside, the 0-2. Fastball just off the corner. One ball and two strikes. Adam Godwin has been ferocious at the plate. 4-for-13 this series with three stolen bases. Next pitch, swung on and foul tipped into the glove for strike three. Two strikeouts in the frame, and Diaz maybe trying to work his way out. He threw some high cheese and got Godwin to chase.
Blake Galen
moves forward with two men out. He lined out to center field in his first at-bat. One of the scouts who were at today's ball game was talking about his efficiency in not only pulling the baseball from the left side of the plate, but his efficacy in delivering the same type of power to the left center field gap as the pitch is stroked to the netting. No balls and one strike. Galen had one opportunity to make it to Double A, and he struggled in that process. He'd been waiting all those years. He went to UNLV without a scholarship, eventually worked his way to the starting lineup with UNLV. He was not drafted out of Las Vegas, so he decided to go to independent baseball. The pitch is stroked into left field. Pretty well hit. Peter Barrows on the move. He's nearing the track. He's at the wall. That ball is gone. Grand slam home run for Blake Galen to the opposite field. It hit off the netting. That ball kept on carrying, and the Bluefish are trailing by a score of 4-0. That ball did not like it was hit all that well. But the wind is slightly drifting out towards left field and may have helped the baseball carry just above the second wall into the netting. 4-0 the score. Diaz awaits the next toss, swung on and missed. Boy, Galen made him pay. No balls, one strike, two men out. The Bluefish are going to need some offense against the Llama. And the early going, they picked up a walk, but were unable to score him. The 0-1 from Diaz. Pitch swung on and sent foul to the left side. No balls, two strikes. All of those runs are unearned because the Adam Godwin strikeout would have been the third out of the frame. Luis Lopez's miscue at third cost the Bluefish four runs. Which include his E5, which allowed Ryan Harvey to score on the Grand Slam, and then the Grand Slam coming up. The 0-2, fastball high, one ball, two strikes. Galen continues to rock the Bluefish now with three home runs against the Fish this year. And now is a team leading 10 home runs. He's one of the Atlantic League leaders in that category. 1-2, a high fly sent towards right center field. Prentice Redmond on the move, so is James Simmons. Simmons makes the catch as he calls off Redmond for the final out of the frame, but not before. Four-run score on two base hits, the big shot. A grand slam to the opposite field by Blake Galen. At the end of an inning and a half, it's 4-0. Barnstormers on top. You're listening to Perry Miles on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Fans, have you heard about the clubhouse? Conveniently located in Fairfield, it has an unparalleled team of baseball and softball instructors offering private instruction, camps, team training, rentals, and best of all, the chance to learn from an all-pro team, including Mike Porzio, former MLB pitcher, and the Bluefish's very own Willie Upshaw. Open 7 days a week. Stop in and meet our team or call us 203-292-8700 and visit us at the web, theclubhouseCT.com, and get the Major League experience.
This is Paul Segura.
Baseball legend Henry Aaron reflects on his Hall of Fame legacy.
I think that since I played for the public, they need to share what I did in my life as far as baseball. It's the proudest moment of my life to give everything to the Hall of Fame. I often tell people they need to get and see it. There is no other building in the world like the Hall of Fame in baseball.
Celebrate the game. Celebrate the legacy. Connect with Cooperstown at baseballhall.org. Mike Piazza talks about the Baseball Hall of Fame.
It just connects you with the history of the game and the tradition of this game and how important this game is to the fabric of society. It's something I used to bond with my father, and I will always, and I love to sort of teach my kids the history of baseball.
Preserving history, honoring excellence, connecting generations. Connect with Cooperstown at baseballhall.org.
Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball is here on the air. Perry Miles with you guys at the ballpark at Harbor Yard. Third baseman Luis Lopez steps in, followed by Angel Flores and James Simmons. The big shot, the grand slam by Galen. The Bluefish are hoping they can get some runs on the board. They'll need it today for Diaz, who has struggled in each of the first two innings. As the first pitch to Lopez bends low, one ball and no strikes as it's outside. Lopez on the year, 284, three homers, 28 RBI. He waggles the bat with an open stance. The first pitch was outside, the second one to the outside corner at the knees. One ball, one strike. That pitch was also slightly higher. The infielder's playing deep. The outfielder is playing back, except for the corner outfielder Lentini in right. The next toss is over the outside corner. One ball, two strikes. Not too many pace balls drop in the outfield. The only problem yesterday, really, was from the infielders. You talk about so many errors. The only positions that did not have errors yesterday, as the next toss is outside, two balls, two strikes for the shortstop Pedroza and the catcher, Francisco Hernandez. But there were a few wild pitches, a few pass balls. Terry Tiffy not to mention Cody Kirkland and Emerson Frosthead, all committed errors. The infield was exposed for a day. The 2-2 grounded towards third, scooped up on a couple of hops by Tiffy. He delivers to first, one away. 5-3 on the putout. Springs Angel Flores to the dish. Flores started yesterday. Luis Rodriguez was not feeling well. 1-for-4 in yesterday's ball game. Continues to keep his average up in spite of the limited at bats. 3-14 on the year. Even though Michael Morris retired, Angel seems to understand the way that pitchers are able to perform and seems to understand sequencing somewhat better. The one out tosses outside, one ball, no strikes. It's all about calling the game the right way. And in patterns which the pitcher and the catcher are on the same wavelength in terms of communication. The 1-0, fastball right down the middle, one ball and one strike. Rodriguez was known for that throughout his time with the Bluefish the last few years. And this year, too, pitchers love throwing to him because they do not need to work too hard on the mental side of things. The next toss is on the outside, quarter ball, two strikes. Pitchers are thinking one thing, catchers are thinking the same. Synchronized communication is great. Implicit synchronized communication is wonderful. The 1-2 from Halama gets the sign, set up inside from Hernandez. Pitch swung on and driven out to left field, pretty well hit. But Blake Galen's nearing the track and makes the play as he drifted onto the dirt. Two outs in the frame on a long L7 to set up James Simmons. Or at least what was supposed to be James Simmons, which it is.
Center fielder, number 7, James Simmons.
Kennard Jones getting the day off. He's been playing almost every day. Almost every single game he's been in. Time for him to get one day today and then another game tomorrow, because there is no play for either of these teams. They'll shift this series back to Lancaster. The first pitch is outside, one ball and no strikes. Tuesday night affair, J.D. Durbin against Toby Stoner, the 1-0. Fastball cruises to the outside corner and connects, one ball, one strike. Matt Pike always talked about early in the count, early contact, or getting behind the count. Getting ahead, getting behind, early contact. Two of those threes are positive for pitchers. Getting behind in the count does not mean 0-1. It means 0-2, 1-2 for the batter. And unless there are pitches that are made towards the middle of the plate or towards the outside corner, when command is the most effective tool, then the Bluefish pitchers will be successful. The pitch is stroked in the air towards the right field line, giving Chase Lentini. He makes the play towards the chalk in fair ground for the final out of the frame. We've completed two from the ballpark at Harbor Yard after a 1-2-3. The Bluefish are down 4-0. You're listening to Perry Miles on BridgeportBluefish.com. We'll be right back.
The YP.com website is your local search engine. If you're looking for a good restaurant, it can help you find the right one nearby with ratings and reviews. Or if your car breaks down, you can use the YP app to find the closest repair shop. Or maybe you're just looking for something to do on a Friday night. Well, it has great local coupons for all sorts of things in your area. No matter what, when, or where, if you're looking for something, YP Local Search can help you find it. So go to YP.com or download the app to search local, find local, and save local.
The Gear Shop at the ballpark at Harbor Yard is your one-stop shop for everything Bluefish. Take a break from the action and check out all your Bluefish souvenir favorites. From men's and women's t-shirts and a wide selection of home, road, and other trendy hats, to Fear the Fin rally towels, team photos, and commemorative baseballs. The Gear Shop has it all. Don't forget about our kids' wear section, game-worn jerseys, even your own stuffed BB the Bluefish, and more. The Bluefish Gear Shop is located on the third base side of the concourse level at the ballpark at Harbor Yard and is open on game days. Come and browse all your favorite Bluefish apparel from an hour before the first pitch until the final out is made. Can't make it to the ballpark on game day but still want to support Fairfield County's only professional baseball team? Then check out the new Bluefish online store at bridgeportbluefish.com or call 203-345-4800 to schedule an appointment. The Bluefish Gear Shop, perfect gifts for all ages and all sizes. Located at the ballpark at Harbor Yard, 500 Main Street, Bridgeport, Connecticut.
The Bluefish broadcast is presented by BridgeportBluefish.com. Perry Miles with you guys for the season. Felon Lentini moves forward. He's followed by Emerson Frostin and Jaime Pedroza, 4, 5, and 6 in the order as Raymar Diaz makes his way to the hill. First pitch to Lentini is on its way. Righty-righty situation. The setup is inside. The pitch rotates towards the middle. No balls and one strike. A grand slam separates these two teams. Grand slam, Blake Galen, the second. All four runs unearned. The 0-1, check swing, went through the zone. Did not matter, called a strike anyhow. No balls and two strikes. Philant Lentini, 9 years of independent baseball beforehand, 3 years of affiliated as the next toss is lifted foul to the netting. No balls, two strikes. He has a concentrated effort, a concentrated approach where he just follows the bat through the zone and spoils tough pitches. One of the teams that's known for doing that is Southern Maryland. Next toss, fastball up, one ball and two strikes. Bluefish infielders playing at least three quarters of the way back. The outfielders playing about straight away. Except for Redmond, playing a little bit further in. The 1-2. Check swing, went through the zone. Strike three as Raymar Diaz has struck out two today in his 2 1/3 innings of work. Four runs allowed, but none of them earned at this point as Emerson Frostad moves forward. Frostad. What a story about him. From Canada, takes hitting practice and practices during the wintertime in Arizona with Justin Morneau. Sure, he also practices with the likes of Jason Bay, who continues to work out in the big leagues. The first pitch fastball on the inside corner, no balls and one strike. Bay, actually a member of the New York Mets and got back from injury in his first home run the other day of the year. Mets doing quite well. Yankees are too. They're taking on the Nationals today. The Bluefish and the Barnstormers from the ballpark at Harbor Yard. The pitch is on the inside corner. No balls and two strikes. The Bluefish have won the last two games against the Barnstormers after Lancaster won the first four games of the ballpark to start off 2011. The next toss is sent foul to the netting. No balls and two strikes. Diaz at one point during the wintertime was reaching anywhere between 92 and 95 miles per hour on a consistent basis, touched 97 winter ball. Conditions were conducive to an adrenaline pump. He threw the ball very hard because his muscles were able to loosen up, not the same way as much with Bridgeport as the 0-2 is outside and high, one ball, two strikes. Not only are you getting players from your own country performing in Puerto Rico these days, to play at the Atlantic League level, but you're also getting players that were some of the best in Australia, in other winter ball locations who you might not see elsewhere. The 1-2. Swung on and missed. Strike three. Consecutive punch outs for Raymar Diaz. Both of them swinging. Two away to bring up Jaime Pedroza. With two away, the shortstop moves forward. So many fans at the ballpark today. It's just not quite what it was for fireworks night as the first pitch lands inside, one ball, no strikes, but certainly a large crowd for this weekend set. Circus Olay is in town at the Webster Bank Arena right across the street. But fans have made their way to this venue to watch the Bluefish perform as the 1-0 is right on the inside corner. One ball, one strike. So many wrinkles to Atlantic League Baseball. The entertainment aspect, where kids get the autographs of their favorite players and they get to run the bases after the game is over, like the way that Bridgeport has. Yesterday was a fireworks spectacular. 1-1 is a fastball outside, two balls and one strike. In Long Island, it's the Quackers. Those are the noisemakers, almost like groggers, if you will. Noisemakers that have the sound of the way that ducks quack. Or in Lancaster or Southern Maryland, different promotions that they will have around the Atlantic League. Quite entertaining. The 2-1 is lifted high in the air towards right center field. The second baseman, Plexky, bats golf, and the ball drops in for a base hit. Redmond Fields takes his time delivering to the shortstop, Eddie Rogers, at the second base bag. It is a single for Pedroso off the very far end of the bat. Nearly broke the barrel. Brings up Ryan Harvey. There is a sumo wrestling event in Southern Maryland in Camden.
Hitter number 35, Ryan Harvey.
A hair company essentially sponsoring the best hair day at the ballpark. So many different wrinkles to Atlantic League. Let's not forget about the style of players that are performing on the field. The throw to first is not in time. You have guys like Southern Maryland whose starting rotation is ridiculous, and whose offense strands a ton of base runners. The same way with Lancaster, the difference is they drive in more runs and get a little bit better pitching from the bullpen. The next toss is swung on and missed. No balls and one strike. Guys on York, they're mostly power hitters, not necessarily stolen base threats. And their starting staff led by Corey Thurman. The Bluefish, mainly recognized for their bullpen and the way that it has been shut down for the most part this year. The 0-1 swung on and missed. The throw to first is not in time. Jaime Pedroza took a little bit of a lead, but was able to return. Two steals and three attempts for Pedroza this year. He has above average speed over first. And Sugarland, free swingers and power pitching. That team resembles, even though their starting staff has been inefficient for the most part this year. The 0-2 fastball guided outside, one ball and two strikes. There's a different feel for every team in the Atlantic League, and it also depends on the park that the team plays in. If you play in a park like York, where it's a short left field and a very shallow left center and jet stream in right, you want the best right-handed hitters in the market available, or the best professionals available from the right side. The 1-2, slap foul to the right. Out of play, a ball and two strikes. If you're in a place like Lancaster, you may decide to go with left-handed hitters like Blake Galen, Emerson Frostad, Brad Boyer. Those guys can hit the ball 300 feet, hit the wall, come up with singles and doubles that way. Many of the fly balls hit in batting practice would go about the same distance. The 1-2, slider away, two balls, two strikes. It's been a tiresome set of innings for Raymar Diaz. Two balls, two strikes. He pins the glove at the thigh and brings it up to the shoulder. The runner goes. The 2-2 is sent high in the air, foul down the right field line. We thank everybody for tuning in on this beautiful Sunday afternoon at the ballpark in Harbor Yard. Father's Day Sunday at the ballpark. Perry Miles here. The Bluefish and the Barnstormers. Lancaster got ahead with a grand slam from Blake Galen. That happening right before Terry Tiffey ended the inning on an F9. The 2-2 stroke foul down the right field line out of play. Two balls, two strikes. The Bluefish in the early going had gotten plenty of strikeouts and not walked too many batters when they were ahead in counts. But Willie Upshaw's main concern was the inability for the team to throw good enough pitches to where it would be tempting to swing at without them making contact. The next toss is inside. Two balls becomes three balls and two strikes. As a result, the batting averages with two strikes with the batter behind in the count are much higher than what they normally should be. And one of those players has been Raymar Diaz. He's already walked three today. The runner goes, the 3-2, swung on and fouled right off the mask of Flores. The only conceivable notion, if this trend continues, maybe to just throw off the batter, slow him down a little bit, down 2-2, throw something that you're not used to throwing. Batter won't know what's going to come in. Same way that Toby Stoner did when he invented his knuckleball. The 3-2, runner goes, pitch on the outside corner. Strike three, Diaz strikes out the side in the third. Runner left on a one base hit, end of 2.5. Bridgeport trailing 4-0. You're listening to Perry Miles on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Wants you to win the greatest weekend that never happened. The ultimate Vegas weekend for you and a buddy. Just collect Miller Lite Taste Points for your chance to win one of 100 Vegas trips being given away this summer for the big weekend. So grab Miller Lite and seize the summer at tastepoints.com. It's that easy, and it never happened. It's Miller time. No purchase necessary. Open to legal U.S. residents 21 or older. Void in California and where prohibited. Sweepstakes begins 5-1-12 and ends 8-1-12. For details, how to enter and complete official rules, go to tastepoints.com. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Miller time. Don't check your wrist or follow up with your supervisor, because Miller time has nothing to do with when and everything to do with who.
What's up, Tommy?
Miller Lite is brewed for the guys you're proud to call your brothers, who'll always talk you out of getting that faux hawk and never talk.
Nice.
During your backswing. Ow. And when you've got your brothers and the light beer that tastes like a beer should,
yeah.
It's not just a good time, it's Miller time.
Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
Shark tooth, screwdriver, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open the new Miller Lite Punch Top Can, but you'll always get the same thing. A smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together? Just like a good team. At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs...
Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball returns on the air. Perry Miles here. As the Bluefish head into the bottom of the third inning, Peter Barrows is in against John Halama. The first toss is on its way from the southpaw. Fastball on the outside corner, no balls and one strike. Barrows out of the University of Bridgeport was signed from the American Association after he spent the 2011 campaign there. Performed very well in the AA, combined with two teams. The 0-1 is lifted down the right field line, but angles foul, no balls and two strikes. It's one of the few times that he had been in the Midwest. After all, the University of Bridgeport plays in the East Coast Conference, and their travels may include going to Florida during the winter months to get some games against colleges such as Lynn College or against Rollins College down there. The 0-2 is sent foul on a check swing. No balls, two strikes. But the East Coast Conference, you're playing teams like Queens and Dowling if you're at the University of Bridgeport, along with CW Post. Schools that some of them have very good baseball programs. Dowling, matter of fact, had one of their graduates, Wilberto Ortiz, playing for the Long Island squad. Tom Panino, part of Stony Brook, in D1. The 0-2 lands on the inside corner, strike three, as Barrels took it all the way. The second strikeout of the day for Halama as it brings up Joe Pilecki. Two relatively inexperienced hitters. Barrels, just one other season on his belt, the left fielder, and Joe Pilecki, the second baseman.
Joe Pilecki
is stepping up to the plate. Probably going to be taking some cuts at the ball. Pilecki, two RBI. Yesterday, picked up his first two career RBI. The first pitch lands outside, one ball and no strikes. Go figure, a year out of college. Joe Pilecki has himself a job with the Bluefish, at least for the time being, as the 1-0 is lifted high in the air toward right center field, but playable for Adam Godwin, who makes the catch for out number two. F8 on the score sheet. And this season, Pilecki is 0 for 13 with those two ribbies. Sets up Elliott Ayala. The problem with the Bluefish has been the combination of players being picked up and the injuries that have surfaced with Pedro Lopez and others have warranted the additions of Peter Barrels, Joe Pilecki. Not to say that they are bad players, but they're inexperienced when it comes down to ALPB action. Two out tosses, low, one ball, no strikes. Barrels getting his first real exposure at the ballpark at Harbor Yard after spending just 42 games in professional baseball last year. And Pilecki was called from his regular job to compete. The 1-0 is outside, two balls, no strikes. He was a fixture at Quinnipiac, and his uncle was one of the better players in Quinnipiac history. Elliott Ayala did not go to Quinnipiac. He was a very good player coming out of the Bronx, as the 2-0 is on the outside corner, two balls and one strike. Ayala now living in Utah as the 2-1. Swung on a broken bat looper towards right field. It drops in for a base hit. Ayala continues his hitting, a four-game hitting streak. And in the last eight-plus games, now nine, he's had hits in eight of those contests as the right fielder Lentini delivered the toss over to Brad Boyer, who was trying to trail the ball, try to make the leaping grab. Single to right field to bring up Eddie Rogers. Halama has mostly tossed on the outside corner and has occasionally dissected the inside with guys like Peter Barrels and Joe Pilecki to go back into the opposite direction. Two-way in the bottom of the third. Eddie Rogers is there. Lefty-righty situation. First pitch lands low, as it appeared maybe Rogers stretched his hands out thinking it was inside. One ball, no strikes. Plenty of running movement from Halama's baseball as he stands tall with the glove, the belt. The 1-0, fastball may have confused the catcher, Hernandez. Pitch seemed to go lower than normal, two balls, no strikes. It also may have confused the home plate umpire for today's main event, Matt Beaver. Two balls, no strikes, two men out. Halama's a decent pickoff move as Rogers distributes the ball foul on the right side. Two balls and one strike. Wind starting to pick up a little bit more. It is the bottom three, the ballpark. 2:05 first pitch, then Bridgeport will head on the road to take on the Lancaster Barnstormers for another three-game series. The 2-1 slides inside, 3-1. And at that time, Bridgeport will have to adjust because they're going into a much better hitter's park than the ballpark at Harbor Yard, even though Bridgeport's pitching has not had as much success as what it would like. The 3-1 is lined on one hop. It is partially bobbled by Pedroza. There is no play. It was a humpback line drive that Pedroza tried to field as he shifted to his right and slightly in. He was caught towards the middle, and I believe it was ruled as an error, and E6 to Pedroza to allow runners to move to first and second. Prentice Redmond at the dish. It was a floating line drive and something that caught in the middle of Pedroza. The next toss is on its way to Prentice Redmond. With two men out, the pitch swung on and missed. Lunged in an off-speed delivery. Away, no balls, one strike. There's a reason why Palama's earned run average is at 2.67, because he gives up very few runs, and any runs that he does give up in chunks, he's able to limit his number of earned runs. He's given up 8 unearned runs this year. The next toss lands low. One ball and one strike. 28 runs total, 20 earned, now in 69 innings worth of work. ERA is very solid as he continues to weigh in for his options. The 1-1 floats to the inside corner, a ball and two strikes. Every toss seems to be a floater from Halama. He's thrown more curveballs and changeups in this inning than we've seen in the first two, which may be a factor later on in the game, the third time around, trying to mix it up with the rest of the Bluefish hitters. The 1-2, fastball away, two balls, two strikes, and he's really not getting too much with his velocity. But soft-tossing pitchers tend to throw off the Bluefish hitters. Look at what Corey Thurman seems to do every time against the Bluefish for the Revolution. Several pitchers seem to have their way. 2-2 the count. Center fielder Godwin angled towards left center field. Runner partially goes. Pitch is grounded slowly towards short. Handling is Pedroza. He delivers to first in time to retire the side. 6-3 on the put out. The Bluefish pick up a hit. They leave two runners on. At the end of 3, 4-0 Lancaster on top. You're listening to Perry Miles on BridgeportBluefish.com. We'll be right back.
A sizzling, succulent filet mignon, scrumptious salmon Florentine, savory twin grilled pork chops. Getting hungry? Your table awaits at the Park City Grill, Fairfield County's elegant new dining spot in the beautifully renovated Bridgeport Holiday Inn. Comfortable, warm, and inviting, Park City Grill offers a world-class dining experience at reasonable prices. Come to the Park City Grill, 1070 Main Street in the Bridgeport Holiday Inn. Take I-95, exit 27A to exit 2. Plenty of free, secure parking.
At Miller Lite, we believe if you're not choosing a light beer with more taste, you need to man up, not man down. Because up is way better than down. You don't tell someone sad to cheer down. What's down, dog? A steamy pile and you just stepped in it. Your girlfriend's not wearing a push-down bra. It's called gravity, Isaac Nitwit. Can I be down front with you? All this down talk is bringing me down. So don't man down, man up, and choose a light beer with more taste. Triple Hops Brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team. At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
Bridgeport Bluefish baseball starts off the fourth inning with a ball low and outside from Raymar Diaz. One ball and no strikes. Bridgeport had a couple of base runners on in the last frame, but were unable to string together much more than that. The next toss is lifted foul down the left field line out of play. The big shot Grand slam from Blake Galen in the second inning, which has accounted for all the Lancaster runs as one ball, one strike. The 1-1 on its way from Diaz. He's set. The pitch on its way from the right-hander is grounded foul to the first base side. An excellent grab by the fan in the front row. Just behind the Bluefish dugout, one ball and two strikes. 4-0 the score, four runs, three base hits, no errors, no runs, two base hits and one miscue. The next toss, fastball on the outside corner, called strike three. Four outs in a row made by Diaz through the strikeout. Sandwiched by a Jaime Pedroza single, one away in the fourth, and it sets up Francisco Hernandez. There's a trivia question for today. Which member of the Bluefish has had the most doubles this year? Which member of the Bluefish has had the most doubles this year for the Fish? Send me an email, perrym86@gmail.com. And if you want the prize, when was the last time that this hitter picked up a double? Which day was the last time that Bluefish hitter picked up a double? The next toss is on the inside corner. No balls and one strike. PerryM86@gmail.com. You can also follow me on Twitter, just me, P. Miles. Just me, P. Miles. The 0-1 from Diaz. Swung on and missed. High cheese. No balls, two strikes. Diaz seems to have settled down in each of the last couple of innings after giving up a series of base runners, but it may have been too late. A crooked inning, as Danny Putnam put it yesterday, or last year rather. Putnam said that crooked innings could do damage and even result in lost ball games. Pitches lifted foul to the left. No balls, two strikes. But if Diaz is able to keep this total at four, it is possible for the Bluefish to make their comeback if they can work enough pitches in the counts to be able to eliminate John Halama and perhaps get to that less than stingy bullpen of the Barnstormers. The pitch is sent foul to the left. No balls, two strikes. ERA has been tremendous except against the Bridgeport offense. And Halama has been great. Three scoreless innings with just two base hits, as it has been changed officially. Eddie Rogers no longer an E6, it is a base hit. It was a very difficult play to make, and that was what the assessment was, a walk for Ayala as well. Hernandez steps out of the box to control. He is a catcher, so he understands what the philosophy is. Control the rhythm yourself. The 0-2 is low, one ball, two strikes. Because as a catcher, he tried to make the pitcher work quickly in a rhythm. The pitcher would love to do that, but the batter has the option of stepping out of the box or even calling it for a timeout. Hernandez doing the same, trying to control the at-bat as much as he possibly can. The 1-2. Check swing. Did he go? Yes, he did, says the home plate umpire, and the tag is applied for another strikeout. Raymar Diaz has struck out six batters today, all coming within the last three innings. Five out of the last six batters in the Lancaster lineup have struck out, and he's retired each of the last seven Barnstormers hitters. Brings up Adam Godwin. Very difficult to strike out Adam Godwin, but that is exactly what happened on high cheese. Last time up on a swing and a miss. Godwin waits. Lopez creeping in at the lip of the infield grass. Diaz delivers. First pitch right on the corner. 0-1. Raymar is 6'8". When asked about whether or not he thought about playing basketball, he said he was talked to about that as the pitch is low and away. One ball, one strike. But there's a certain shape that a basketball player would need to get in order to become that kind of player. And he did not want to become a basketball player. He loved baseball more. He thought he had an opportunity to make it to the big leagues, even though he went to high A. As the pitch is lifted towards second, and Paletsky could not time it. He went sideways, and by the time he tried moving back, he could not make it there. A base hit for Godwin on a jam shot line drive. Paletsky has been confused by those in-between shots, in between a line drive and a pop fly, and sometimes very difficult to judge. Usually a fielder's first instinct is to move back, the same way that an outfielder would before charging forward. It's much more difficult to move back because you're using more energy to backpedal. Can't move as quick unless you're sprinting forward towards center or left center. Another throw to first is not in time. Diaz will be checking on Godwin. Seems every moment that he's on base, he's already reached twice. Top of the order has not done a whole lot of damage the last couple of games, which is why Hobson might have switched Blake Gaylen from where he was hitting yesterday, the three spot, to the two hole, get him maybe one more at bat during a game as another throw to first is not in time, but also to place Lentini in four, maybe to drive in some runs because he's done that against the Bluefish. So many changes to the lineup and such little time for Hobson to make those proper adjustments. The runner goes, the two out toss is high. The throw to second is towards right center, but Eddie Rogers catches before it could flare out there. Angel Flores had plenty of time to throw the ball, but by the time he did throw the ball, it was way off the mark. Eddie Rogers had to veer towards the right field line in order to get the ball as he crossed over the second base bag. Two men out with a runner in scoring position for Lancaster, and they have a chance to score another one in this inning. The 1-0 fastball, low, two balls and no strikes. It is a gorgeous day. The sun beating down on the field again after having such a rainy week when Lancaster was last here. Camden was here. It was quite rainy as well. The 2-0 fastball inside, three balls, no strikes. The inclement weather forced the postponement of one game to make a doubleheader. The River Sharks swept that doubleheader, and the Bluefish were reeling at that point. This is the final game of a 10-game homestand. If the Bluefish win today, they will have gone 4-6 during that stretch of games. Fortunately for them, that is the case, but they're right now trailing 4-0, and 3-7 would not look all too good for this Bluefish squad. Tiny conversation taking place between Flores and Diaz. It seems that there's been a meeting every single inning between whether it be Serafini or Flores and Diaz. Next toss is served high in the air to deep left center field. Simmons on the move. He stops near the track and makes the play as he banged into the Budweiser sign in left center for the final out of the frame. The Bluefish give up a hit, but they leave that runner in scoring position. No runs in the inning for the Barnstormers. At the end of 3.5, it is 4-0 Lancaster on top. You're listening to Perry Miles on BridgeportBluefish.com. We'll be right back after these words from our local sponsors.
Jimmy Rollins talks about the Baseball Hall of Fame.
Just being in the same place that all these great ball players, you know, reside at now, their career, you go find their stats, their jerseys, their helmets, their cleats, and have something of mine, that is something that anybody that goes to the Hall of Fame can see.
Preserving history, honoring excellence, connecting generations. At the National Baseball Hall of Fame and Museum in Cooperstown, New York. Connect with Cooperstown at baseballhall.org.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team. At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
Looking for something to do that the whole family will enjoy? Then drop on by the box office at the Ballpark at Harbor Yard to pick up your individual game tickets for Bluefish Baseball today. With three great seating options, field box, loge, and reserved, every seat gets you up close and personal with the action at Harbor Yard. Mondays and Tuesdays are Kids Eat Free Nights presented by Friendly's and the Big Y Supermarket. Thirsty Thursdays, presented by Budweiser, are back this year, followed by giveaway nights on Freebie Fridays.
Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball is back. Perry Miles here, John Halama on the mound for his fourth inning of work. As the Southpaw weighs in against Brock Peterson, Luis Lopez and Angel Flores, 4, 5, and 6. Halama deals first pitch swinging and missing. No balls, one strike. Peterson has been performing very well for the Bluefish. This season, 11 homers and 35 RBI in the short run with Bridgeport. The next toss, chopped on the ground, foul to the first base side. No balls and two strikes. All in Family Fun Sunday, presented by the Bluefish. The autograph session, and kids get to run the bases after the game's over. A fun-filled festive Sunday from the ballpark at Harbor Yard, but Bluefish fans not too happy about the results on the field. Still trailing by 4. Peterson bounces on the ground to third, handled on the backhand. The flip to first is in time by Terry Tiffy over to Emerson Frostad. One away on the 5-3 to set up Luis Lopez. Terry Tiffy grew up playing the hot corner and also the first base area. Emerson Frostad, the Texas Rangers organization, did the same. The difference is when Tiffy got to the big leagues, he was asked to play a different role, third base, because when he was there, it was Justin Morneau, and the designated hitter could be any one of a number of players. Could have been Tiffy, could have also been a guy like Jason Kubel, the one-out toss, a fastball away, one ball, no strikes. Could have been Lou Ford on occasion, a former Long Island Duck who made his way back to the affiliated ranks with the Orioles, spending much time away from the game. In indie ball, the 1-0 curveball on the inside corner, one ball, one strike, and there is a chance that three players could make the jump from independent baseball to the big leagues this year based on the depth of all of these major league teams. One of them is Lou Ford. One of them, as the 1-1 is a fastball low, two balls and one strike, is Ryan Garko, and the other one is Joey Gathright. Garko is now a member of the AAA Rays in Durham. Meanwhile, Joey Gathright, who's performing very well, is with the Louisville Bats, the Cincinnati Reds organization. The fastball turns away. Three balls and one strike. It is a possibility that those three will get opportunities in the big leagues this season, when last year the only person to really get an opportunity to go from independent to the big leagues was Jerome Williams. An excellent story, a former Barnstormer in his own right. The 3-1 is outside, ball 4. Luis Lopez walks. He is one of the league's leaders in that category heading into today, and he continues to increase that number as he draws his first bases on ball of the day. He is just 2 behind Brian Bergamy. Now make it 1 after that walk. Bergamy walks quite often, probably going to be an all-star. 3 of the 5 leaders in the Atlantic League in bases on balls belong with the Bluefish. 2 of them are active today, and 1 of them is not in the starting lineup today due to hand injury, sore hand. Pedro Lopez is suffering from. The first pitch lines up with the outside corner, 0-1. Lopez not quite displaying the kind of speed that he once did. One time was a very good base runner, very good stolen base threat. The 0-1, inside, one ball, one strike. Double-digit stolen bases during some years of his career. Coastal Carolina undrafted, he had to prove everybody wrong. Bluefish entering today, hoping to win another game. That would make him too shy of 1,000 for the team. I'm sure there will be a celebration for that. The 1-1 is stroked in the air toward right center field. Adam Godwin circles over from center and makes the play on an arc as he darted across. 2 outs in the 4th. It is an F8 on the score sheet, and it brings up James Simmons. Simmons has provided everything that the Bluefish have wanted in a center fielder defensively. They're still waiting for him to break out offensively. He was batting below 200 entering today, and he's still below 200 with the 0-for-1 in the contest. Center fielder starts up, even stance, waggles the bat, pitch, grounded sharply through the hole on the left side for a base hit. A walk by Lopez, a single by Simmons, runners at first and second for the Fish to bring up Peter Barrows. This is a big spot in the game for the Bluefish. Both of the rallies have been with two men out in back-to-back frames. They are hoping to put some runs on the board. And one of the ways that Peter Barrows might be able to do that is if he directs his baseball towards right center field. There is a large gap in right center field, which if he hits perfectly could score two runs, knowing how much speed Simmons has. The two out toss is a high pop to the right side of the infield. The first baseman, Emerson Frostad, is called off by the second baseman, Brad Boyer, who makes the play for the final out of the fourth. No runs, one hit. Two runners left on at the end of the four innings. The Bluefish are down by a score of 4-0. You're listening to Perry Miles on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Hey kids, it's not too late to join BB and all of his friends by becoming a member of the Bluefish Snappers Club. The Snappers Club is the newest club for all the biggest or littlest Bluefish fans. As a member of the Snappers Club, you'll not only get free entrance on Snappers Club Day, but you'll also get a membership card to show all of your friends, plus a special t-shirt that will tell everyone you're a member of the club. After each Sunday home game, Baseball Bunch members will also be invited onto the field to run the bases, just like the Bluefish do. You'll even receive a newsletter that will fill you in on all of your favorite Bluefish players, along with all the news that BB Snappers Club has to offer. To join the coolest club around, call 203-345-4800 or go to BridgeportBluefish.com/kids/snappers to become a member of BB's Snappers Club.
A sizzling, succulent filet mignon, scrumptious salmon Florentine, savory twin grilled pork chops. Getting hungry? Your table awaits at the Park City Grill, Fairfield County's elegant new dining spot in the beautifully renovated Bridgeport Holiday Inn. Comfortable, warm, and inviting, Park City Grill offers a world-class dining experience at reasonable prices. Come to the Park City Grill, 1070 Main Street in the Bridgeport Holiday Inn. Take I-95 exit 27A to exit 2. Plenty of free, secure parking.
Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball is back. This call to the bullpen presented by Prudential Annuities. Prudential Annuities going to bat for our community. Raymar Diaz goes four innings, gives up four hits, four runs. None of those are earned. Three walks and seven strikeouts. 93 pitches, 57 of them for strikes. Seven strikeouts is one of his highest totals as a member of the Bluefish, but the only blemish on his resume was that grand slam by Blake Galen, which separates the two teams from each other. Terry Tiffy moves in against Mike Tarsi, the left-hander. That who is entering the game. He's had plenty of double-A experience and some triple-A experience out of Danbury, Connecticut. He continues to deliver. He throws anywhere between 88 and 90, 91 miles per hour. Left-handed tosser usually comes in, not necessarily in mop-up situations, but in scenarios where they need a pitcher for longer than an inning or two. Last time out, two innings pitched and a strikeout. This is his eighth game of the year. An ERA of 2.35 this season. He's just been a tremendous addition after trying out in spring training for the Fish and not making it to the team initially before he was called in. His services were requested, and because Tarsi was allowed to come on board. Franklin Groseski was released from the squad. The first pitch fastball lines up at the outside corner. No balls, one strike. Groseski made it to the team, but then struggled with a lower body injury that eventually cost him some velocity, and the Bluefish right-handed reliever was unable to recover from that. No balls, one strike from Tarzi to Tiffy. He's 0-for-1 with a walk. Next toss lands low, scooped up. One ball and one strike. So many events taking place in the Atlantic League. Third baseman Pedro Feliz back with the Camden River Sharks, which certainly boosts their ball club. Eduardo Perez started out the year as the third baseman. That may not be the case anymore, as the River Sharks are looking to improve their ball club both offensively and defensively. The pitch is stroke found to the right. One ball, two strikes. If that means getting rid of Eduardo Perez and replacing him with the third baseman Pedro Feliz, who's played AAA in Big League Baseball for quite some time, then why not do it? Feliz toward the latter end of his career anyhow. He played so many seasons with the San Francisco Giants organization. Willie Upshaw familiar with the way that he played the game and with the kind of aggression and passion, both offensively and defensively, to perform to help the Giants to at least a one World Series berth. A 1-2 ties him up, strike three. Tiffy goes down as he's jammed. But Lantini moves forward with a fly ball to left and a strikeout on his resume. Every team is trying to get better at this point of the season. The Bluefish are certainly hoping to do that. Starting pitching has been the main issue for the Fish most of the year. The ERA just of late had shrunk just below 6. After being in the 6s for quite some time, your starter's ERA is 6. The team's not going to win many ball games. Pitch is a jam shot, inside out, poke, foul, down the right side, out of play. No balls and one strike. It's all about starting pitching in this league. Southern Maryland has it. Their problem is their offense is so anemic that it really does not matter. They were hoping to get Casey Benjamin back. They did, and it still has not made that much of a difference, even though Benjamin has been producing a little bit. Travis Garcia, bone chips. He, too, was out. The 0-1. Swung on and grounded towards the middle. Diving snag by Pilecki. He gathers and throws to first in time. What a play by the local product out of Riverside, Connecticut, a suburb of Greenwich. A sprawling play as the ball had eyes for right center field. And he gets his jersey and his pants dirty for that play, but it was worth it for the Bluefish fans who cheered him on. Two away on the 4-3. Lentini's a fast guy, too. Sped up the first base line. Pilecki was able to snag on the backhand a full body sprawl. Emerson Frostad moves forward. Tarsi deals, grounded towards first. Peterson gathers and delivers to Tarsi, covering for the final out of the inning. A 1-2-3. Probably the shortest inning in terms of pitches that the Bluefish have had. It's the first 1-2-3 inning of the game for the Bluefish pitching staff at the end of 4.5. Bridgeport still trailing 4-0. You're listening to Perry Miles on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Shark tooth, screwdriver, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle-nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open the new Miller Lite Punch Top Can, but you'll always get the same thing. A smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together? Just like a good team. At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
This is Terry McGriff, pitching coach for the Bridgeport Bluefish, and you listen to Perry Miles on the Bluefish broadcast.
Second baseman, number 5, Joe Paletsky.
Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball returns on the air. Perry Miles here. The Bluefish still down by a score of 4-0. And after an outstanding play made by Paletsky to record the second out of the inning from Philan Lentini, Paletsky leads off and is hoping to come up with a more productive at-bat. The third baseman, Terry Tiffey, is at the lip of the infield grass in anticipating what Paletsky may do. The first toss on its way is a fastball outside, one ball, no strikes. Paletsky has had some good swings. Last night he was robbed by the corner outfielder Blake Galen of an extra base hit. As he sprawled to the dirt, a cloud of dust came up and Paletsky was robbed. The next toss is outside, check swing. Did he go? No, says the first base umpire for today's contest, Chase Edmondson. Two balls, no strikes. We're in the bottom of the fifth inning. John Alama is one of the league's leaders in innings pitched. He's also thrown a complete game as the next toss is swung on and missed. Two balls and one strike. Done quite well this year. Alama, complete game, 4-3, 2.67. Among the league leaders in earned run average to boot. And he's not allowed too many home runs. Next toss, fastball. Sent outside, three balls and one strike. Joe Paletsky has not reached on either a single or a walk. He did reach on an error once. Perhaps he's getting more comfortable at the plate with the more reps that he gets. The 3-1. Fastball away, ball four. Paletsky walks. It is the first time in his Bluefish career that he has walked as he gets a congratulations and a congratulatory slap five from Jonah Bayless, who's the first base coach for this afternoon's contest. A slew of players will do that. Bayless probably will not be performing today. Dan Tarsi's day is today, and Bayless is in the starting rotation, so why not have him be the first base coach? The throw to first is not in time. Paletsky has never seen Halama before today. Halama has a great pickoff move. Paletsky has not shown great speed to this point, but we will see how much of a lead Paletsky takes. Halama waits, lifts his leg, and delivers. Swung on and lifted foul to the right. No balls and one strike. Halama just wanted to test him out. Halama was one of the better pitchers in picking off players in the big leagues. Him and Andy Pettit were outstanding. They were almost two peas in a pod except on different teams. Both crafty left-handed pitchers, with Halama throwing much harder during his A-day, 94 miles per hour, 95. These days not nearly throwing as hard. Pettit continuing with his career in the Yankees organization. The 0-1 is grounded toward short but throws a field. Flips the second one onto first. Not in time. Throws a little high and off towards the home plate side of the first base bag. Fielder's choice for Elliot Ayala as he reaches on the 6-4. It eliminates Paletsky. Sets up Eddie Rogers. Only runs of the game scored on a grand slam in the second inning. And since that point, it has been a difficult obstacle to overcome for the Fish. Going to need some base runners and potentially some hitting with runners in scoring position. The one out pitch is outside. One ball, no strikes. Entering this game tied for second in innings pitch with 66 and one-third innings tossed. With this start being his 10th of the year. So he's averaging seven innings start as the next toss is over the outside corner. One ball, one strike. It's all because of his efficiency. Lancaster owns the best road record in the league at 13-12. But Bridgeport also owns the worst home record in the league, 11-15. They just have not been able to perform at the ballpark at Arbor Yard for whatever reason. The Llama stares in, the 1-1 twists inside as Rogers had to jut out of the way just to avoid getting hit. Two balls, one strike. And as this game goes along, you may see some action in the bullpen, which is exactly what is happening down the left field line. Llama may only go five. The Bluefish have been able to work deep counts in each of the last couple of innings. And the Lancaster bullpen last night really was not exhausted. Six innings from Brockman, and then two more from Horacio Ramirez. So those two will not be available as the next pitch is squib foul. Two balls, two strikes. Day before, there were three pitchers involved. So Lancaster has their share of pitchers that they can go to. Let's not forget about the way that Dwayne Pollock performed six innings of baseball in the opener. Lancaster's bullpen is open for business. If Llama is struggling any bit, Hobson will not hesitate to go to his pen. The pitch is lifted high in the air down the left field line, but it twists toward the picnic area foul as it hits the canopy. Two balls, two strikes. Four runs, four hits, no errors, no runs, three hits, one error. Lefty-righty situation upcoming. Two balls, two strikes. Southpaw delivers. Fastball low. Three balls, two strikes. Runner at first base is Elliot Ayala. He's got some speed. Will the runner be going again on 3-2? Llama set. Rogers also. He waggles the bat. The runner goes. Pitch is swung on and missed. The throw to second is not in time. Ayala got in there by a hair. Stolen base for Ayala. His first of the season that's been successful is Eddie Rogers strikes out swinging. Prentice Redmond must move forward. As he's 0 for 2 on the day. The Bluefish aiming for their first run. Redmond 0-4-2, 5-3 and a 6-3. Two out toss, curveball over the middle of the plate, no balls and one strike. The flag whipping out in left field, well towards left. Any baseball that's hit towards left center may angle towards left. The 0-1, fastball away. One ball, one strike. Llama shaking his head. It appeared he did not appreciate where that baseball went. The intent was to go maybe 2 inches off the corner, around about 2 feet off the corner. 1-1 the count from the Brooklyn native to Redmond. Pitch, Scott in the air to the right side of the infield. Should be playable for Brad Boyer. He locates it in the sun and makes the catch for the final out of the fifth. No runs, no base hits, a runner stranded in scoring position. End of five, Bridgeport down by four. It's 4-0. You're listening to Perry Miles on BridgeportBluefish.com. We'll be right back.
Miller Lite. We know there's only one thing baseball fans love as much as great Pilsner taste, and that's rooting for the home team. Because home is way better than away. Away is not where the heart is. Bringing away the bacon? Why? Bacon is delicious. Away is where you hang your hat? You should be hung up by your underpanties. So why root for the away team when you can root for the home team? With a great Pilsner taste of Miller Lite. Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Shark tooth. Screwdriver. Golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on. Grill fork. Tuning fork. Fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key.
There's lots of things you can use to open the new Miller Lite Punch Top Can, but you'll always get the same thing. A smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. Shark tooth, screwdriver, skeleton key, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, the lucky fishing lure you snagged Alan with, sorry Alan, drumsticks, chopsticks from the place you met that Dallas-based flight attendant, a motel key, let's not talk about the motel key, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. How do these things make Miller Lite from a can even better? Find out May 2012. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
A poem entitled Coors Light Summer. It's a Coors Light summer, hot babes all around. Backyard barbecues are where you'll be found. It gets pretty hot out, but it'll be all right because coolers are filled with ice-cold Coors Light. You step outside, mini skirts galore. Be your garden for the ball game, that's what's in store. It's gonna be a scorcher, but there's hope in sight. Refreshment awaits, frost-brewed Coors Light. Thank you.
Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
Bluefish baseball is back for the top half of the sixth inning. Jaime Pedroza steps up, followed by Ryan Harvey and Brad Boyer. 6-7-8 against Mike Tarsi as he drops the glove down to the belt. The first pitch on its way from the southpaw is lifted high in the air to center field. James Simmons tracks back. Backpedals and stops before he corrals. One away on the F8 as Ryan Harvey moves forward. The difference in the game is that grand slam. No earned runs allowed, but Raymar Diaz could wind up going to 1-6 on the year. His ERA is going to drop because of that. But the no earned runs allowed is indicative of the way that Bluefish pitchers have of late been able to wiggle in and out of jams. Not necessarily the case for the Bluefish right-handed starter today. Matter of fact, that's one of the only times that the Bluefish have hit the Barnstormers have hit with runners in scoring position in this series. The first pitch tossed away. One ball and no strikes. And they'll have to come back against the combination of Halama and the rest of the relievers as Tarsi did not like the feel of the baseball. He goes for a new one. One ball, no strikes. We want to wish everybody a happy and healthy Father's Day today. The 1-0 on its way. A high sky ball to left center field, trying to track it down the shortstop. Eddie Rogers is called off by the center fielder, James Simmons, who makes the play in left center, in shallow left center, as the left fielder, Peter Barrows, is making his way there. Two away on the F8 to spring Brad Boyer to his next at-bat. Plenty of fans here for the Father's Day celebration. Great time had by all.
Number 7, Brad Boyer.
The question is whether or not the Bluefish would be able to continue to improve on the way that they had been able to perform. It's just not been quite the way that one might expect. The two-out toss from Tarsi. Fastball slides to the outside third. No balls, one strike. The expectation for the Bluefish was to have a very good season with not as many home runs, but plenty of contact hitting, bunting, and running. And it seemed for quite some time that the Bluefish went away from that philosophy, losing Joey Gathright and Colin DeLome in the process. The 0-1 is whiffed. No balls, two strikes. They did not even start out the year with Colin DeLome. They had Dan Stange, of course, who was a player who threw anywhere from 92 to 96 miles per hour on the radar gun. And let's not forget about the other players, like Chris Pettit, who was originally supposed to sign with the Bluefish, but got an offer from the Arizona Diamondbacks organization, signed with them before the season began. The 0-2, check swing, did he go? No, indicates the third base umpire, Matt Hensel. No balls, two strikes. Bridgeport a few days ago was at their low point of the year, the low watermark, 7 games under .500. And the Bluefish fans were wondering when was this team going to turn it around. Luis Lopez would love for the fans to be patient. The 1-2 slips away, two balls, two strikes. But at some point, the players need to get executed. Otherwise, the team is going to fall a little bit off. Last couple of years, the Bluefish have had their backs pinned against the wall. 2010, they had the
the core players to make that comeback and that run. Last year, they were in great spirits until they lost their final game against the Road Warriors and went into a tailspin the last 2 weeks of the year. The 2-2 is chopped on the ground to the right side. Handling is Paletsky. He throws to Tarsi, covering for the final out of the frame. It's a 4-1 put out for Brad Boyer. That ends the any threat. It's a 1-2-3 for the second inning in a row for Tarsi. At the end of 5.5, the Bluefish are still down by a score of 4-0. You're listening to Perry Miles on BridgeportBluefish.com. We'll be right back.
Lightbeer.com website is your local search engine. If you're looking for a good restaurant, it can help you find the right one nearby with ratings and reviews. Or if your car breaks down, you can use the YP app to find the closest repair shop. Or maybe you're just looking for something to do on a Friday night. Well, it has great local coupons for all sorts of things in your area. No matter what, when, or where, if you're looking for something, YP Local Search can help you find it. So go to YP.com or download the app to search local, find local, and save local.
The Gear Shop at the ballpark at Harbor Yard is your one-stop shop for everything Bluefish. Take a break from the action and check out all your Bluefish souvenir favorites. From men's and women's t-shirts and a wide selection of home, road, and other trendy hats, to Fear the Fin rally towels, team photos, and commemorative baseballs. The Gear Shop has it all. Don't forget about our kids' wear section, game-worn jerseys, even your own stuffed BB the Bluefish, and more. The Bluefish Gear Shop is located on the third base side of the concourse level at the ballpark at Harbor Yard and is open on game days. Come and browse all your favorite Bluefish apparel from an hour before the first pitch until the final out is made. Can't make it to the ballpark on game day but still want to support Fairfield County's only professional baseball team? Then check out the new Bluefish online store at BridgeportBluefish.com or call 203-345-4800 to schedule an appointment. The Bluefish Gear Shop, perfect gifts for all ages and all sizes. Located at the ballpark at Harbor Yard, 500 Main Street, Bridgeport, Connecticut.
Is a comeback in store for the Bluefish. They are down by a score of 4-0 in the bottom of the sixth inning. Brock Peterson makes his way to the dish for another at bat. The Bluefish have had opportunities in each of the last three innings, but John Halama has stayed solid and has been able to escape any jam that he has faced. The first pitch on its way from Halama is a fastball directed to the outside corner, no balls and one strike. So much success for Halama in this game and during his career. He could choose to walk away from the game at any time, but he's still effective as the 0-1 is lifted high in the air down the right field line, giving chase Lentini. He tries to track it down and makes the play. He sprawled towards the chalk, landed halfway in the grass with his glove in the dirt, and he makes the play, diving towards the right field line. Peterson robbed of a potential extra base hit. Counts as an F9 on the score sheet to bring up Luis Lopez.
Third baseman number 19, Luis Lopez.
There have been other games taking place today in the Atlantic League. The Southern Maryland Blue Crabs leading the Long Island Ducks 6-3 in the bottom of the sixth. New York Revolution, Somerset Patriots 9-2 in the bottom half of inning 9 from TD Bank Ballpark. The one out toss is over the middle, no balls, one strike. The Sugarland Skeeters took down the Camden River Sharks 5-1. So if Bluefish somehow makes a comeback, they would not only be able to make up ground possibly on Long Island, but also on Camden, which is already a final from Campbell's Field. The 0-1. A high grounder to third, handled by Tiffy, takes his time and throws a dart to first, two away. Not too many pitches thrown by John Halama today. He's gone through 5 2/3 innings, thrown 81 pitches. That's a pretty good number for the pitcher. As Flores stands in, he is 0-2. Just 3 hits in the lineup for the Fish. Halama's at the 80 pitch mark. The 81st is over for a strike on the outside third. No balls, 1 strike. He's just been solid. Changing speeds, changing locations, keeping the hitters off balance. And the Bluefish, any time that they have dealt with some of these soft-tossing lefties, it has been a problem. Soft-tossing righties, too. The 0-1 fastball races inside. 1 ball and 1 strike. Halama right now is at a Triple-A level of baseball. He continued to throw very well in Triple-A, even to his last stint. The 1-1 fastball cruises outside, 2 balls and a strike. It's the first time that Halama's really delivered 3 pitches, well, more than 3 pitches in an at-bat. Flores waiting one more time. He's 1-for-4 in yesterday's game. The 2-1, grounded sharply towards the middle. It is a base hit to left center field. It went by Pedroza. Flores picks up the Bluefish's 4th hit of the game, matching Lancaster's total. The difference is the Bluefish really have not had too much to cheer about in terms of power as James Simmons steps up to the dish.
Center fielder, number 7, James Simmons.
Simmons, a fly ball to center and a single in the 4th. With 2 men out, stands in. Halama waits and delivers. Swung on and missed. Halama took a little bit off of the fastball, threw a change up in the dirt. No balls, 1 strike. Thank you everybody for tuning in today. A beautiful day at the ballpark. The 0-1 lifted in the air towards right field. It is a base hit as it drops in front of Lentini. Nice stroke from Simmons. We'll see if Peter Barrels gets the opportunity. It appears that he will go to the plate this time around. But if it's later on in the game, you may see Kennard Jones if Peter Barrels does not do damage this time around. Butch Hobson is coming out of the dugout to walk to the mound. He is taking a long time to walk out there, not to just talk to Hobson, or rather not to just talk to Halama, but to give his relief pitcher an opportunity to warm up. I believe it's number 14, Jason Urquidez in the bullpen, who is a right-handed pitcher out of Tarzana, California. Butch Hobson taking plenty of time to get his right-hander ready. This may be the last batter that Halama faces all day. If Peter Barrels picks up a single, it's possible that Angel Flores would score, which would make the move even bigger. The Bluefish really limited in their bench in this contest. They have 6 infielders, 4 outfielders, and a catcher on their roster, with Luis Rodriguez inactive. Their backup catcher is Peter Barrows, who's listed as one of their outfielders. It would be very difficult to go in that route, although Elliot Ayala has played in that regard. The only other possibility would be to send either a pitcher or one of their injured players, such as Pedro Lopez, who's dealing with the hand issue, out to the field. The 2-out toss, a check swing, did not matter, call the strike. No balls, 1 strike. It is not that Barrels has been overwhelmed in this league. Just not quite getting the type of swings he was early on as he lays the bat towards the shoulder. The 0-1 grounded softly towards short. Pedroza gathers and throws to second to retire the side. A fielder's choice and a 6-4 to end any threat. The Bluefish leave 2 more runners on at the end of 6. It is 4-0 Lancaster on top. You're listening to Perry Miles on BridgeportBluefish.com. We'll be right back.
Miller Lite wants you to win the greatest weekend that never happened. The ultimate Vegas weekend for you and a buddy. Just collect Miller Lite taste points for your chance to win one of 100 Vegas trips being given away this summer for the big weekend. So grab Miller Lite and seize the summer at tastepoints.com. It's that easy, and it never happened. It's Miller time. No purchase necessary. Open to legal U.S. residents 21 or older. Void in California and where prohibited. Sweepstakes begins 5-1-12 and ends 8-1-12. For details, how to enter and complete official rules, go to tastepoints.com. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Miller time. Don't check your wrist or follow up with your supervisor. Because Miller time has nothing to do with when and everything to do with who.
What's up, Tommy?
Miller Lite is brewed for the guys you're proud to call your brothers. We'll always talk you out of getting that faux hawk. And never talk. During your backswing. And when you've got your brothers and the light beer that tastes like a beer should, it's not just a good time, it's Miller time.
Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
Shark tooth, screwdriver, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, pork fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open the new Miller Lite Punch Top Can, but you'll always get the same thing. A smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together? Just like a good team. At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball returns in the top half of the seventh inning with the Bluefish down 4-0. Raymar Diaz goes four innings and gives up four runs, none of them earned. But he's on the short end of this game. It's 4-0 so far. Blake Galen with the big shot, a grand slam to left field in the second. We are in the top half of the seventh inning. And we also have the trivia question answered. The pitch is sent high in the air to deep left center field. Peter Barrow's on the move, and he makes the catch as he had to fight off the sunlight and the imposition that was the wall as he banged it to the Rita's Isis sign in left center for the first out. Long drive by Francisco Hernandez, and F7 on the score sheet to set up Adam Godwin. The trivia question for today, which member of the Bluefish was able to pick up the most doubles this season? And the answer is Prentice Redmond. The next question would be, when was the last time that Prentice Redmond picked up a double? The next toss is on the outside corner, no balls and one strike. And if you've been listening to the broadcast, you would know right away when that was. And if you did not, then obviously it will be a much more difficult task to tackle. The 0-1 lunged at and missed. No balls, two strikes. The last time that Prentice Redmond had a double was opening game of the series. So the appropriate date would be 6-14 of this year. That was your trivia question for today. The Bluefish have had some questionable swings against Alama's. The next pitch is tossed away. One ball, two strikes, but only because Alama's been very good. There are 100 games during a season which the outcome is almost predetermined. And this may be one of them where Alama throws a great game. There's nothing the Bluefish can do. It's the other 62 in a major league season or 90-52 split in minor league season. Pitches diving low, two balls, two strikes. The other 52 games, let's say in a minor league season, are the ones that would be up in the air. And if you win many more of those games than you lose, then the team is going to be very successful in contention for the postseason or even getting to the postseason. The winner of the Atlantic League last year, the Long Island squad, wasn't that far above 500. Pitches lifted high in the air towards left of center, where James Simmons took a look, break, and makes the catch on the FA for out number two. Adam Godwin today is 1-for-3. It's not to say that they were a bad team. They were a very good team. They were the best team numbers-wise regular season throughout the year. But if you consider if 90 games are out of reach, 45 in favor of your side and 45 against you, then the other games determine whether or not you're going to be a well above 500 team or not. And those are solely based on how close the competition is. The next toss is on the outside corner, no balls, one strike. How often you have opportunities to hit with runners in scoring position? 11-7 ball game may be well out of reach until a certain point, or it may have been an 8-7 game till late because another team did not hit with those same runners in that position. The 0-1 is outside from Tarzi, one ball and one strike. It all depends on the situation, the circumstances surrounding that. And the Bluefish are hoping that their circumstances are different today because trailing 4-0, pitch bounced into the ground to first. Brock Peterson handles and goes to the bag as he waved off the pitcher, Tarzi, for the final out of the inning. Three scoreless frames for Tarzi out of the bullpen. The Bluefish still down 4-0. You're listening to Perry Miles on BridgeportBluefish.com. We'll be right back. This is the seventh inning stretch.
We believe if you're not choosing a light beer with more taste, you need to man up, not man down. Because up is way better than down. You don't tell someone sad to cheer down. What's down, dog? A steamy pile and you just stepped in it. Your girlfriend's not wearing a push-down bra. It's called gravity, Isaac Nitwit. Can I be down front with you? All this down talk is bringing me down. So don't man down. Man up and choose a light beer with more taste. Triple Hops Brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Shark tooth, screwdriver, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open the new Miller Lite Punch Top Can, but you'll always get the same thing. A smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team? At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community, by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial Inc.
This is Terry McGriff.
The Bluefish had all kinds of problems handling John Halama, but Butch Hobson has decided to go to the bullpen, and this call to the bullpen presented by Prudential Annuities. Prudential Annuities going to bat for our community. John Halama is out. Number 14, Jason Urquidez, moves forward. He was part of the epic matchup, which featured the mistake made by Butch Hobson in the lineup due to Jesus Merchan and his departure from the team as the first pitch is on its way from the right-hander Urquidez. He lines up a strike over the middle, no balls, one strike. Joe Paletsky leads off. He had a walk in his last at-bat. Really never faced Urquidez in his career. Aquita is ready. He deals again. Fastball right down the middle as Paletsky just let two fastballs go right there. No balls, two strikes. And you wonder if Aquita's will go third time with the fastball. The 0-2 fastball up, one ball, two strikes. First two fastballs were towards the outside corner and middle of the plate, respectively. And then went upstairs to change the eye level. Perhaps Urquidez will go more towards a breaking pitch this time around to fool the right-handed hitter. The 1-2, a high pop to first, shading his eyes, jogging in and making the catch. Emerson Frostad for the first out. Not much of a chance for Paletsky. He bailed out with the front foot and then just poked it about 90 feet to the right side. One away on the P3. It brings up Elliot Ayala.
Designated hitter number three, Elliot Ayala.
A walk, a single, and a fielder's choice ground ball. 15 for his last 36 as the pitch trails away. One ball, no strikes. Let's take a quick look at the Atlantic League scoreboard update and then the Major League update, courtesy of PointStreet.com, AtlanticLeague.com, and ESPN.com as the next toss is waved at for a strike. Sugarland 5, Camden 1. That's a final. Somerset defeated York 3-2 today. So the Patriots have won a few games in a row. The 1-1 waved at for a strike. Again, a ball and two strikes. Southern Maryland 6 and Long Island 3. That's in the bottom of the seventh inning. As the Bluefish, they just need to win games and get some help. That's ultimately what they need, what it comes down to. The 1-2, a high poke foul down the right side. One ball, two strikes, and against Aquina has already one out in the frame. 8 outs to go, and to make up a minimum of 4 runs as Wynn Pelser makes his way to the bullpen area. He's been throwing for a minute or two these days. The 1-2 is inside, 2-2. Other pieces of news from across golf and baseball will be coming up. Tiger Woods appears to be 5 shots behind Graham McDowell and Jim Furyk as the next pitch is outside, 3 balls, 2 strikes. U.S. Open, one of the majors in golf. Of course, the Masters, the British Open, two of the others are involved, and the Players' Championship as well. The 3-2. Fastball inside, ball 4. Urquidez walks Ayala. He has taken his bases on ball for the second time in the game to bring Eddie Rogers to the dish. So Graham McDowell, Jim Furyk at 1 under par. They're expected to take to the tee at 6:10, 6 o'clock tee time for Frederick Jacobson, 2 strokes back. Nicholas Kolsarits is 3 strokes back along with Blake Adams, Ernie Els, Lee Westwood, John, and then Tiger Woods is 4 under par, 4 over par rather, and he probably will be taking his tee time shortly if he already hasn't taken off for the final round action. An interesting piece of news, actually, is the pitch is outside. One ball and no strikes. In golf, Tiger Woods has never trailed going into round 4 and actually won a major championship. Something I did not know yesterday that was revealed during a particular radio show. The 1-0 is on the outside corner. One ball and one strike on a fastball. Eddie Rogers 1-for-3 today. He's hoping to put on a great show in this at-bat with Urquidez dominating the way that he has for Paletsky's at-bat and then got Ayala down before the designated hitter worked his way back into a favorable or more favorable position. The 1-1 from the righty before Urquidez has to step off as Rogers wants to take some more time. In Major League Baseball, the Yankees lead the Washington Nationals 4-1 in the bottom of the eighth inning. Nobody on. The Yankees had Ivan Nova going to the hill against Edwin Jackson, the longtime journeyman. The 1-1 is lifted foul to the right. One ball and two strikes off the netting. The Mets defeated by the Cincinnati Reds 3-1. The Red Sox and Cubs, 8 o'clock Eastern from the Windy City Wrigley Field. Those are your scores locally. In NCAA baseball on this Father's Day, lots of games. Late Florida State and Stony Brook coming up. Loser of that matchup is eliminated from the College World Series. UCLA, Arizona, coming up as well. The winner of that game will play the winner, or rather, pitches popped up to the right side. We'll get to the explanation in a moment as Frosted moves forward and makes the catch with Urquidez covering first, two away on the P3. Whoever loses the Florida State Stony Brook matchup is eliminated, and the winner of that matchup will play the loser of UCLA Arizona for the right to play the winner of that matchup. If Florida State wins that matchup, then Florida State will play either UCLA or Arizona. If Florida State wins, then they'll play either the winner of the initial matchup. One of those teams will go 2-0. It's a double elimination process with 18. The two-out toss is over the middle. No balls, one strike. NBA Finals taking place tonight from Miami, Florida. Oklahoma City Thunder, Miami Heat. 8 o'clock Eastern tonight. 0-1 from Urquidez. Drops the glove down to the stomach and rips it right by Redmond. No balls, two strikes. LaDainian Tomlinson has decided to retire, and he's going to do so as a Charger. One of those formalities, signing a one-day contract worth $1 as the 0-2 is sent high in the air, foul down the right field line, out of play. No balls, two strikes, two men out. And that's the way that it's been. And the last piece of information, Nats reliever Brad Lidge has been designated for assignment. He had done such a great job coming back with the Phillies a few years back as the pitches rotated outside. Count one ball and two strikes, which means any team could possibly sign his services, but they would have to arrange a trade agreement for some prospect if he were not to be traded within a certain period of time. If he does not accept the assignment, as the 1-2 is yanked foul down the left field line, two balls, two strikes. If a player does not accept an assignment, then that person could be released or could be traded within a certain period of time, or released for the rest of the individuals to pick up. It's quite a complicated process. The player could accept the assignment and remain on the team until there's another injury and prove again that that player is worthy. The 1-2. Check swing. Did he go? No. Indicates the first base umpire as Terry Tiffy jutted towards the Lancaster dugout from third base. He thought Redmond had gone all the way through the zone. Two balls and two strikes. Righty stands in. Gets the signal. Set up is outside from Hernandez. Pitch swung on and missed. That time he got out of the inning. Redmond is 0 for 4. The Bluefish have surrendered another base runner on the base paths. At the end of 7, 4-0, Lancaster on top. You're listening to Perry Miles on BridgeportBluefish.com. We'll be right back.
If you're not choosing a light beer with more taste, you need to man up, not man down. Because up is way better than down. You don't tell someone sad to cheer down. What's down, dog? A steamy pile and you just stepped in it. Your girlfriend's not wearing a push-down bra. It's called gravity, Isaac Nitwit. Can I be down front with you? All this down talk is bringing me down. So don't man down. Man up and choose a light beer with more taste. Triple Hops Brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
A poem entitled Coors Light Summer. It's a Coors Light summer, hot babes all around. Backyard barbecues are where you'll be found. It gets pretty hot out, but it'll be all right because coolers are filled with ice-cold Coors Light. You step outside, mini skirts galore. Be your garden for the ball game, that's what's in store. It's gonna be a scorcher, but there's hope in sight. Refreshment awaits, frost-brewed Coors Light. Thank you.
Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
I call this little ditty America's pastime. Summer's here and it feels pretty nice. Baseball and hot dogs and refreshment on ice. Some games are early, some are at night, but there's always a beer man with ice-cold Coors Light. He's the most reliable player in the game. All it takes is calling his name, so even if your team doesn't hit any dingers, you'll have frost-brewed refreshment at the tips of your fingers. Thank you.
Frost-brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
I called this one best girlfriend ever. It had been a long day and an even longer week, so I headed toward the kitchen, refreshment I did seek. But after swinging open the fridge, I saw the most horrific sight. Not a single cold beverage, not a single Coors Light. I grabbed my keys, it was time to hit the store, but stopped when I heard a knock at the door. It was my girlfriend, bearing gifts of Coors Light. Best girlfriend ever? You got that right.
Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
A sizzling, succulent filet mignon, scrumptious salmon Florentine, savory twin grilled pork chops. Getting hungry? Your table awaits at the Park City Grill, Fairfield County's elegant new dining spot in the beautifully renovated Bridgeport Holiday Inn. Comfortable, warm, and inviting, Park City Grill offers a world-class dining experience at reasonable prices. Come to the Park City Grill, 1070 Main Street in the Bridgeport Holiday Inn. Take I-95 exit 27A to exit 2. Plenty of free, secure parking.
It was the bottom of the seventh inning when the Bluefish did not score a run against Jason Aquides. And this call to the bullpen for the Bluefish presented by Prudential Annuities. Prudential Annuities going to bat for our community. It is a new pitcher, Wynn Pelzer, on the hill. The first pitch is stroked in the air towards center field. James Simmons on the move and has to play it on a hop to a late break. It is a single for Terry Tiffy to lead off as Lentini comes into the box. After Tiffy's at bat, first pitch stroke off of Wynn Pelzer, who's been solid with the Bluefish since joining the team. 7 games, 9 2/3 innings, just 2 earned runs, even though he has allowed 5 runs total. A 297 opponent's batting average against. He has allowed 8 walks. That has been his Achilles heel. He's been giving up way too many walks. He has a heavy fastball and a very good set of off-speed pitches that he can provide. But he's just not been able to do that as effectively this year as he once did, as the first toss is on the outside corner. Clips the edge, no balls, 1 strike. Former University of South Carolina, a baseball player, his team in the College World Series. And he was psyched about hearing about his team performing on one of the biggest stages in Omaha, Nebraska. A number of players in the Atlantic League have performed at that high level, as the 0-1 is a fastball away, 1 ball, 1 strike. And in college baseball, it's not quite as big until you get to the College World Series, even though there are quite a few teams out there. South Carolina, Florida, Rice, UCLA, which is another team that's in the race. Kent State has become a big baseball power. Let's not forget about some northern teams that have made there recently, such as Notre Dame. And let's not forget about Stony Brook, who's in the College World Series. The 1-1 is sent high in the air, deep to left field. Peter Barrow's moving back. He's near the track. He's at the wall. That ball is gone. 2-run shot for Lentini. And the Bluefish now trail by a score of 6-0. When Pelzer left the pitch up, Lentini lifted it out. His 6th home run of the year, RBI, number 24 and 25. And the Bluefish are now down by more than a grand slam. It's 6-0. A Blake Galen grand slam, a 2-run drive by Lentini, and chances are, you think about it this way, Luis Lopez does not commit that error in that inning. Perhaps the results are different with Blake Galen in the third inning, which is when his at-bat would have come up. The next pitch is chopped into the ground to the right side. Paletsky handles and throws to first. It's not in time. I believe that was Emerson Frostad that beat it out. I believe that was. That was a great amount of speed being displayed by Frostad. He hustled out of the box on the big chop. And Paletsky could not quite get it there. It is ruled as a base hit. And already Wynn Pelzer giving up 3 hits in the early going to this Barnstormers lineup. Pedroza settles in as Pelzer delivers the first, winning 5 out of 7. against the Bridgeport squad would be great for this Lancaster team. Anytime you win 5 out of 7 on the road, regardless of what team it is, you're doing a great job. The next toss is over the inside corner, 0-1. Pedroza is 1-for-3 with a single in the third. Strikeout in the second and a fly ball to center in his last at-bat in the sixth. Next toss way outside. And Peltzer started to grab the right side of his body. It is a tough sport. Little nicks. And there are some major pains involved with that. 1-1 from Pelzer. Lifted foul to the netting. One ball, two strikes. Post-game show comes to you following the conclusion of this ball game. Scores and summaries from around the Atlantic League and also the big leagues. Yankees taking full control of their game against the Nationals. Boy, they have dominated the National League so far. The 1-2 sent foul to the left. A ball and two strikes. This is about the time where the Yankees took over first place. They are dominating almost everybody on their schedule. The only teams that they really haven't played are the Dodgers and the Texas Rangers, two teams that are considered by many to be the top teams in the league. Yankees a little bit under the radar because of the way that the Rangers had won two straight American League titles. Pitch is lifted foul to the left. One ball, two strikes. Yankees would make it 9 in a row victory-wise with a win against Washington, heading back to Yankee Stadium to take on the Braves and then finishing up the interleague sets with the New York Mets this weekend at Citi Field, or at least the next weekend at Citi Field. 1-2, sent foul to the left, a ball and two strikes. And at some point, the Yankees will start losing a few games, but right now they are steamrolling opponents. They are two games ahead of Baltimore in the loss column. Baltimore has their game taking place in Atlanta. They have been smoking National League teams as well. The Braves really have fallen off. The New York Mets have. Washington has lost two in a row. They're about to make it 3 in a row. Mets have a chance to get within 4 if they're able to win anything. But they were not able to today against Cincinnati. They lost 3-1. Plenty of parity in the big leagues this year. Eventually, the teams with the higher payrolls a lot of times will wind up on the top. 1-2 is swung on and missed. Strike three. Pedroza goes down for the second time today for the strikeout. Ryan Harvey moves forward. E5 in the second, a strikeout in the third, and a fly ball to center in the sixth.
Hitter number 35, Ryan Harvey.
Harvey's been a beast. At least for some part of his career. An all-star early, but he was one of the top prospects that just did not pan out. One out toss on the outside edge. No balls, one strike. And the Red Sox, which is the other local team in the state of Connecticut, really, they have been scuffling. They score plenty of runs. They allow tons of runs. It's not been a good combination. The pitch is inside and it hit him. Howard, or rather Harvey, goes to first. Runners at first and second with one man out to bring up Brad Boyer. Butch Hobson has been experienced with a number of winning ball clubs. This Lancaster team does not have necessarily the feel of the way that Southern Maryland was a few years ago. When the Southern Maryland Bluegrass were playing a few years ago, their pitching was outstanding and their offense produced a plethora of runs for the team. This Lancaster team, it's not to say that they don't have dominant pitching. They certainly have very good pitching, but their offense is not quite as lethal as what that Southern Maryland squad was, as the first pitch ties up Boyer inside. One strike, the count. If you look at Eric Crozier and the way that Jeremy Owens was 2 years ago as opposed to the way that he is now, Christian Lopez during his first year with the team. Travis Garcia with the way that he was able to produce and be in toward the bottom of the lineup. So many pieces that need to be worked around. Casey Benjamin's first year, right after he got dismissed by the Texas Rangers organization, pitches inside on the corner for a strike, no balls and two strikes. The Bridgeport Bluefish can be looked at the same way. 2010, how many players are remaining from that roster? It's not many from the team that won the Liberty Division Championship Series. Many of them have either moved on to different parts of their life. The 0-2. Swung on and missed strike three. Boyer stretched outside the zone and chased an off-speed delivery from Pelzer. The players left from that team. Corey Julio, but he left for a year. Paul Segura, Matt Pike, Dan Serafini. Four pitchers remaining from that team. If you want to count Luis Rodriguez, that's a fifth player on the team. And Luis Lopez. That's it remaining from that 2010 team. Everyone else relatively new. Luis Gonzalez gone. Forgetting about Willie Mopeña, Charlton Jimerson, two out toss on the outside corner, 0-1. Josh Phelps gone. Brandon Chavez departed. Hiram Boca Chica out of there. Tyke Redmond also gone. Related to Prentice. 0-1 to Hernandez. Ducks inside. One ball, one strike. That team would consistently talk about baseball, hitting the baseball. They cared. It felt like a 28-man unit instead of a 25-man unit on the baseball team. They would always talk about baseball, even when going out a little bit. The 1-1 is outside, two ball and a strike. The rigors of the game on the road, best exemplified by the way that front office members are able to participate, the way that fans are able to come out to the game. Let's not forget, the regular hours are 9 to 5, but then there's a ball game, so they must stay over afterwards. It is a gruesome process for many of the front office staff members who are participating in this league. The 2-1 from Pelzer. Swung on and missed. Two balls and two strikes. The runner at second base, Emerson Frostad. Runner at first is Ryan Harvey. When Pelzer's already allowed two runs in this inning, the first time that anybody had scored any runs since the second. Bluefish really hoping to avoid another shutout. They were shut out three times by the River Sharks so far. This would be the fourth shutout loss of the year, and they've never shut a team out to this point. Except for that, for one time. It's been a hard fought time for the Bluefish. The next pitch tossed away. Three balls, two strikes. Believe it or not, the Bluefish have not won in a shutout. They've given up, or actually they did. Southern Maryland was the shutout. Do apologize for that. The 3-2 is inside on the corner, strike three. Three strikeouts for Pelzer, but seven batters come to the plate. Two-run score, two-run shot for Lantini. The Bluefish are down by a score of 6-0 at the end of 7.5. You're listening to Perry Miles on BridgeportBluefish.com. We'll be right back after these words from our local sponsors. Stay tuned.
At Miller Lite, we believe that sharing a pitcher of our great-tasting draft beer will bring friends together for a good time. And good is way better than bad. No one reminisces about the bad old days. If your guess is as bad as mine, then we're a couple of idiot faces. So far, so bad? Turn that frown upside down, grumpy pants. So why have a bad time when you could have a good time with a pitcher of Miller Lite draft beer? Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. At Miller Lite, we believe if you're not choosing a light beer with more taste, you need to man up, not man down. Because up is way better than down. You don't tell someone sad that you're down. What's down, dog? A steamy pile and you just stepped in it. Your girlfriend's not wearing a push-down bra. It's called gravity, Isaac Nitwit. Can I be down front with you? All this down talk is bringing me down. So don't man down, man up, and choose a light beer with more taste. Triple Hops Brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. At Miller Lite, we know there's only one thing baseball fans love as much as great Pilsner taste, and that's rooting for the home team. Because home is way better than away. Away is not where the heart is. Bringing away the bacon? Why? Bacon is delicious. Away is where you hang your hat? You should be hung up by your underpanties. So why root for the away team when you can root for the home team? With a great Pilsner taste of Miller Lite. Triple Hops Brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Shark tooth, screwdriver, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open the new Miller Lite Punch Top Can, but you'll always get the same thing. A smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. Shark tooth, screwdriver, skeleton key, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, the lucky fishing lure you snagged Alan with, sorry Alan, drumsticks, chopsticks from the place you met that Dallas-based flight attendant, a motel key, let's not talk about the motel key, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. How do these things make Miller Lite from a can even better? Find out May 2012. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Lite wants you to win the greatest weekend that never hit.
Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball is expected to be great for the 15th anniversary season, but right now the Bluefish reeling a bit as they are on the verge of going 22-28 on the year. The first pitch from Bo Vaughn is on the outside corner. No balls, one strike. This call to the bullpen presented by Prudential Annuities. Prudential Annuities going to bat for our community. The next pitch is swung on and lifted down the left field line. It is hanging towards the corner, but it just went foul at the last moment. It was hugging the line, but eventually stayed in foul ground. No balls, two strikes. Peterson, Luis Lopez, and Angel Flores, 4, 5, and 6 for the Fish in the order. As Peterson gets his bat back. Strikeout in the first, ground ball to third in the fourth, and a fly ball to right. On his resume today, Bo Vaughn has been one of the better relief pitchers for the Barnstormers this year. 1.62 ERA, 16 2/3 innings, 3 earned runs allowed. Pitch is lifted foul to the right. No balls and 2 strikes. Opponents hitting 186 against Vaughn. Throws a nasty slider, a fastball to change. The Bluefish really got down early, courtesy of Raymar Diaz giving up the grand slam, and also with the facilitation from Luis Lopez and his bobble, or the throw into the dirt, rather. The 0-2 is low, one ball, two strikes. He threw the ball into the dirt after he seemed to make a great play, which would have been the second out of the inning. And then Adam Godwin's strikeout later on would have been the third out, but because it was only 2, Blake Gale had an opportunity, and he sent the ball over the wall and left. The check swing did not go around. 3 balls, 2 strikes. Simple math in the 8th inning. Terry Tiffey singles. Filantini sends a 2-run home run to left field. And that's all the scoring so far today, as the Bluefish are hoping that they could come up with some rally. They would need at least a few base runners to make a threat as the next pitch sways outside. 3 balls, 2 strikes. It is a grind, no question about it. 140 games with 2 days off in each month except the Atlantic League All-Star Game. And it's quite a long period of time for Bluefish fans to wait. The 3-2 is low ball 4. And plenty of games for the Bluefish fans as well as Peterson walks. Bluefish went on the road for 14 games, and in the end, that may not have been the best situation for the Fish, even though the team had no control over where they would go, because after going 7-3 in the 10 games, Bridgeport faced off against Somerset and was really slowed down by that pitching staff. Since that point, Bridgeport has fallen in the offensive categories, and also their starting pitching has been a bit questionable as the next pitch tossed away, one ball and no strikes. In the first three games of this series, the Bluefish starting pitchers had allowed a combined 4 runs, 3 earned. Today, starting pitcher, 4 runs and combined a total of 6 runs in this game for Lancaster. The 1-0 slides to the outside corner, 1 ball, 1 strike. Final scores of 3-1 in game one, 5-3 in game two, and 9-2. Lancaster scored a total of 8 runs. They're approaching that number today. The next toss is away. 2 balls and a strike. If the Bluefish are able to get a couple base runners on, you never know. Bovon has not really felt too comfortable on this mound. Nobody has really complained about it. The 2-1 is outside, 3 balls and 1 strike. But Mike Lurie did mention something about the mound to Kevin Baez, saying he might have slipped a time or two. But ultimately, the grounds crew does a great job in taking care of all the nooks and crannies of the ball field. As it appears that there is a pitcher going to start warming for the Barnstormers, and the pitch is low ball four. Luis Lopez draws a walk to bring up Angel Flores, the first baseman, Emerson Frost, and the shortstop, Jaime Pedroza, quickly run over to the mound to talk with their pitcher to slow him down and give him a boost of confidence. Left-hander Les Walrond is in the bullpen for the Barnstormers. He's already pitched once against the Bluefish this year, as Flores steps in, and he might be used for any upcoming left-handed hitters or perhaps for James Simmons next, who has had some difficulty at times hitting Barnstormer pitching, not today. First pitch, fastball tossed inside, 1 ball, no strikes. Bovon cannot seem to control where he is throwing the ball, where it's landing. Remember this, the Bluefish have decent batters coming up. Still Angel Flores, James Simmons. After that, who knows, maybe Kennard Jones gets a rip or two. The 1-0, fastball directed outside. The count at 2 balls. I believe it's 2 balls and no strikes. And the catcher, Hernandez, comes out to give him a boost of confidence. Butch Hobson comes out there. All of these delays just to get Les Walrond available. Bovon probably not be coming out right now. Hobson takes a look at the video board. I'm sure he watched a little bit of Family Guy as he could see her Stewie Griffin talk, but his focus is laser thin about getting the confidence instilled within the pitcher and also make sure he's back on the right track. Angel Flores, a single in his last at bat. All the Bluefish need are walks and singles at this point. When the time comes, they might have an opportunity to do something else. The 2-0 from Vaughn. Fastball right down the middle, 2-1. Flores taking all the way. And as quickly as that play unfolded, 2 balls, 1 strike. Perhaps Vaughn will go away from the strike zone, try to induce a ground ball. Pitch grounded to third, but foul. Just to the left of the third base bag. 2 balls, 2 strikes. Vaughn has struck out 19 batters in his first 16 and two-thirds innings of work. He's also walked 6 batters, which is a little bit higher than one might expect for a guy with an ERA of well less than 2, just north of 1.5. The 2-2. Swung on and served high in the air towards left center field. It is dropping in for a base hit. Godwin cuts it off and plays the ball into second. It is a bloop single for Angel Flores. The Bluefish have the bases loaded with nobody out to bring up James Simmons. Les Walrond is quickly getting up. He's throwing pitches at a more rapid pace down the left field line for the Barnstormers. He just whipped a curveball out there. Bovon, a couple of walks and a single. Could this be the turn of an epic day at the ballpark? First pitch, fastball, rotates to the outside corner, no balls, one strike. Lancaster obviously would concede a run if it meant turning a double play, which is where their infielders are positioned. Simmons waits. 2-for-3 today. The next toss swung on and served high in the air to deep left center field. It hits the gap. It is a base hit. One run scores. Two run score. Rounding third and coming to the plate, Angel Flores. There is no throw. It is a bases clearing double for James Simmons. RBI number 7 for the center fielder. The Bluefish are on the board at 6-3, and the Bluefish are back in the game. It all started with a leadoff walk, a set of walks by Peterson and Luis Lopez as Angel Flores also made his way to the plate from first base. It was a long drive to the gap, no chance for Adam Godwin to get there because of the pattern of hitting from Simmons. It confused the center fielder Godwin. He was angled more towards right center field. By the time he got to left center, the ball had already fallen towards the gap. Simmons is at second base for Peter Barrows. Nobody out. The first pitch to Barrows. Fastball right down the middle, 0-1. This would be a great time. What will happen next? It's Joe Pilecki waiting on deck. He'll get an at bat for sure. 6-3 ball game. The 0-1. Fastball inside. Went off the glove of Hernandez. No balls. Make it one ball and one strike. James Simmons ropes a double. It's his third hit of the game. Angel Flores with two hits. Lopez has reached base twice with a walk. And Elliot Ayala has reached base three times with a hit and two walks. 1-1, timeout is called. There is action brewing in the Bluefish bullpen as well. What if the Bluefish pull off the unthinkable? Will Jorge Julio get up? It was a 6-0 game to start out the inning. Vaughn's 1-1. A high chopper towards third. It gets by third at short. Pedrosa has to eat the ball. It is a base hit for Barrows. An infield single. He's 1-for-4. Runners at first and second. The tying run comes to the plate in Joe Pilecki. Boy, would it be a wonderful time for Pilecki to come up with his first hit as a member of the Fish. He was not a great power hitter when he was a member of Quinnipiac, and he's not a standard power hitter by any stretch. Made a great defensive play earlier in the game. Right now, Lentini's home run proving critical for the Barnstormers, because a single by Pilecki would essentially have driven in the tying run. Bull Vaughn having all kinds of problems. Les Walrond holding off for now. And you would think Tim Hamulak is in the picture, at least in the near future. Pilecki stands in. The third baseman, Terry Tiffy, is at the lip of the infield grass, anticipating bunt. The slide up the left side. It is a perfect one. The throw to first is in the dirt and scooped up by the second baseman, Brad Boyer. The sacrifice is successful to move Simmons and Peter Barrows up a base. Boy, that was a close play. The second baseman, Boyer, nearly did not get in there. By the time he did, he nearly could not catch the ball on the scoop job. Sacrifice successful. 1-4. Sub runners at second and third for Elliot Ayala. A single away from making it a 6-5 game, possibly. The seventh batter up in the inning for the Fish. All started with a walk. First pitch outside. Bo Vaughn does not have it right now. Walrond is ready in the bullpen. He threw his warm-up tosses, and now there's a right-hander warming up in the bullpen for the Barnstormers. It appears to be a sidewinder. Could not see who it is from here. The next toss on the outside corner might be Ching Lung Lo down the left field line. One ball, one strike. The Bluefish knocking on the door, the 1-1. Swung on and missed, a big cut by Ayala. One ball, two strikes. Ayala has reached base three times today. He has walked twice and singled. Eddie Rogers is waiting in the on-deck circle. The 1-2, way outside. It was tempting, but did not get Ayala to chase. Two balls, two strikes. Well, Vaughn brings the glove back to the chest. The 2-2, swung on and fouled off. A good cut by Ayala. He stays alive. There is some bullpen action for the Bluefish, and we're still determining who that is. Ball being held a long time. The next toss, swung on and missed, strike three. Elliot Ayala goes down swinging, two away. The infielders can move back a bit as Eddie Rogers moves forward. I believe it's Kyle Zaleski down the right field line who was just activated for today's ball game. Hernandez making his way to the mound, but no switch from Hobson yet. He's taking more time. Eddie Rogers, the eighth batter in the inning. Boy, that scoop up as Hobson comes to the mound, and it appears as if he's going to make his way for a bullpen. Eddie Rogers will have to stay in the game. The Bluefish are still waiting as Hobson takes the ball from the right-hander Bovon. He did not have a good day. Two outs in his outing, three runs on the board for the Fish. Runners at second and third with two men out when we return. This call to the bullpen presented by Prudential Annuities. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for our community. We'll be right back after these words from our local sponsors. Stay tuned.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team? At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
The Bluefish are still threatening at the ballpark at Harbor Yard. It is the bottom of the eighth inning. The Bluefish have a 6-3 deficit that they have to overcome, and they'll have to deal with Jeff Bennett out of the bullpen instead of Chin Lung Lo. This call to the bullpen presented by Prudential Annuities. Prudential Annuities going to bat for our community. Eddie Rogers, 1-4-4 today. As he stares in, a single in all likelihood would score two runs. But the importance comes down to whether or not Bennett would be able to give up a hit to Eddie Rogers. Many of the Lancaster pitchers have been able to hold the fort when the Bluefish have threatened. First pitch on its way, swung on and lifted high in the air to left field as the corner outfielder Blake Galen has room and makes the play for the final out of the frame. The Bluefish score three times, but it could have been worse. They leave runners at second and third with one man out. The Bluefish still down 6-3 at the end of 8. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on the Bluefish Broadcast Network. We'll be right back.
Special delivery from W.B. Mason. The W.B. Mason delivery man.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team? At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
Looking for something to do that the whole family...
Behind everything you're searching for is something you're actually looking for. When you flip through the real yellow pages for a plumber, you're actually looking to reclaim your home from a renegade faucet. It's not just getting directions to a tailor with YP.com. It's looking your best for an interview. And it's more than finding a mechanic with YP.com on your mobile. It's getting your road trip back on track. Whatever it might be, there are more ways to search and more ways to find exactly what you're looking for with the real yellow pages, YP.com, and YP.com on your mobile. Only from AT&T. Behind everything you're searching for is something you're actually looking for. When you search with the real yellow pages, you get more than a contractor. You get a whole new curb appeal. It's not just getting directions to a dry cleaner with YP.com. It's rescuing an old favorite from the back of the closet. And it's more than finding a locksmith with YP.com on your mobile. It's getting to sleep in your own bed. Whatever it might be, there are more ways to search and more ways to find exactly what you're looking for with the real yellow pages, YP.com, and YP.com on your mobile, only from AT&T.
A sizzling, succulent filet mignon, scrumptious salmon Florentine, savory twin grilled pork chops. Getting hungry? Your table awaits at the Park City Grill, Fairfield County's elegant new dining spot in the beautifully renovated Bridgeport Holiday Inn. Comfortable, warm, and inviting, Park City Grill offers a world-class dining experience at reasonable prices. Come to the Park City Grill, 1070 Main Street in the Bridgeport Holiday Inn. Take I-95 exit 27A to exit 2. Plenty of free, secure parking.
Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball shifts to the top half of the ninth inning. This call to the bullpen presented by Prudential Annuities. Prudential Annuities going to bat for our community. Kyle Zaleski is on the hill. Leave for the Bluefish. The right-handed pitcher was activated today and is being put into the fire right away. 6-3 the score, 6 runs, 7 base hits, no errors, 3 runs, 8 base hits, and 1 error as Zaleski stares in for the sign. He's been hot and cold this year as Zaleski, as the next toss is on its way. It's flipped outside. 1 ball and no strikes. Zaleski on the year. An ERA between 4.5 and 5. And he's had some outings where he's done very well. He gets his first opportunity as the 1-0 is swung on and missed. 1 ball, 1 strike. 4.5, 6, 25, and 2/3 innings. His record, 2 wins and 1 loss. And against Camden, he's done against Southern Maryland, the Lancaster Barnstormers, rather, he's been very successful. 6 2/3 innings, 2 earned runs, 7 hits, 4 walks, and 7 strikeouts. He's done quite well against this the Barnstormer club as the next toss is on the outside corner. 1 ball and 2 strikes. It's quite a number that Zaleski has. He's going to have to deal with Adam Godwin as the pitch is poked towards the mound, handled to his right. Zaleski throws to first in time, one away. Bluefish had their chance. Joe Pilecki bunted, sacrifice, and it looked as if Bo Vaughn was not getting the ball over the plate all too well. And that bunt may have gotten his confidence up a little bit more to where he could strike out Ayala, and then the pitching change was made for Eddie Rogers. Adam Godwin is out on the 1-3. As he is 1-for-4 on the day for Blake Galen, who has a big shot today, a home run to left field in his for his only hit. It's not necessarily about how many you get. It's about the timing of those hits. The one-out toss is lifted high in the air to right field. Prentice Redmond trying to track it down. He does, as the second baseman, Pulecki, fades away, and Redmond makes the catch. F9 for out number two. It's never been really the number of hits, but the timeliness of the hits. James Simmons picks up the first base hit with runners in scoring position for the Fish all game. It's a bases clearing double, but may have been a little bit too late. Perhaps the Bluefish have a rally in them for the ninth inning when Tim Hamulak is expected to enter. Two out toss, fastball outside, one ball, no strikes. Hamulak has been involved with the Barnstormers for a long time. Him, Ross Peoples, those two are almost native Lancaster players considering the way that they have performed and the way that they've been involved with the community. The next toss is low. Two balls, no strikes. Hamulak's last appearance was in the game that Lancaster won, the only one that they won, 3-1, where he threw a shutout inning, really was unfazed by any extra hitters that he had to face that day. The 2-0. A high bouncer to the right side of the infield. Pulecki has to field and throw to first as he waited for the hop to throw out Terry Tiffey going down the first base line. The Bluefish have one more opportunity. They need three runs to tie and four to win the game. The Bluefish down 6-3 at the end of 8.5. You're listening to Perry Miles on BridgeportBluefish.com.
We don't just make a light beer with average taste. We make one with great Pilsner taste. And there's a big difference between great and average. Nobody strives to achieve averageness. Exploring the average outdoors? Have fun in your backyard, Magellan. If that book was called Average Expectations, it wouldn't be worth Dickens. Average minds don't think alike. They don't think, period. So why settle for average taste when you can have great Pilsner taste? Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Mike Piazza talks about the Baseball Hall of Fame.
It just connects you with the history of the game and the tradition of this game and how important this game is to the fabric of society. It's something I use to bond with my father, and I will always, and I love to sort of teach my kids the history of baseball.
Preserving history, honoring excellence, connecting generations. Connect with Cooperstown at baseballhall.org. Jimmy Rollins talks about the Baseball Hall of Fame.
Just being in the same place that all these great ball players, you know, reside at now, their career, you go find their stats, their jerseys, their helmets, their cleats, and have something of mine, that is something that anybody that goes to the Hall of Fame can see.
Preserving history, honoring excellence, connecting generations. At the National Baseball Hall of Fame and Museum in Cooperstown, New York. Connect with Cooperstown at baseballhall.org.
The Bluefish are in desperation mode at this point because their team is down 6-3 going into the bottom of the ninth inning. And this call to the bullpen presented by Prudential Annuities. Prudential Annuities going to bat for our community. Tim Hamulak fires a strike on the inside edge. No balls, one strike. Hamulak on the year. 3.57 ERA, 2 wins and a loss, 10 saves. He's pitched 17 and two-thirds as he delivers a curveball, which dances inside. One ball, one strike. Redmond, Brock Peterson, Luis Lopez due up. The Bluefish hoping for the comeback today. Lancaster with the victory would salvage a split of the four-game series. The 1-1. Fastball travels inside. Two balls and a strike. The Bluefish got James Simmons to hit a bases-clearing double, and the Bluefish are expected to come back. They may need him to come up there and produce one more time. The 2-1 is a chopper into the dirt foul. Two balls, two strikes. Bluefish post-game show is coming up, and Bluefish are obviously concerned about the way that they are playing. But they're even more concerned about trying to catch some of these teams in the standings, and one of the only ways to do it is by winning. The 2-2 is served foul to the opposite field. Count remains two balls, two strikes. Kids will be able to run the bases after the games as they have lined up down the right field line near the Hi-Ho D'Addario Kids Cove area. Diaz going four. He's in line for the loss. Four hits, four runs, none earned, three walks, seven strikeouts. Tarsi, three shutout innings with a strikeout. Pelser, three hits and two runs, allows the pitches grounded over the third. Tiffy deals and throws to first, one away. Redmond now 0-4-5 after the 5-3 that springs Brock Peterson to the dish. Combined 0-for-8 between those two with a run scored and a walk. Pelser, an inning, three hits, two runs, both earned, three strikeouts. Kyle Zaleski, an inning of work, shutout baseball. Alama, six innings, five hits, three walks, three strikeouts. Urquidez, an inning, and a hit, walk, and a strikeout. Bovon, two-thirds of an inning, three hits, three runs, two walks, and a strikeout. Bennett recorded the final out of the eighth. And Hamulak so far has one out in the ninth as he must deal with Peterson, who has to poke it foul as Hamulak is throwing strikes and grooving it in there. Lancaster's ERA 3.61, easily the best in the Atlantic League heading into today's play. Really do not give up a whole lot of earned runs as the defense has caused them some dear pain at times. The 0-1 lifted foul to the netting. No balls, two strikes. Hamulak not allowing any of this to happen. Bo Vaughn has struggled in the last week or so against the Fish, but Bridgeport needed to find a way in the eighth inning to really make the comeback because you knew that Hamulak was going to be entering there, and Jeff Bennett is a very good setup man. Many of the players had not been used in the first part of the series. The 0-2 just misfired on the outside corner. One ball and two strikes. The infielders playing deep. They have opened up the middle. Pearson waits the 1-2. A high chopper towards third. If it stays fair, it does not, though. If it stayed fair, it would have been a base hit, but chopper went right to Butch Hobson, who's waiting in the Lancaster dugout, and tosses to a young fan out there who is waiting to give it to a kid. One ball and two strikes. One man out. Peterson stares in, looks. Pitch, foul tipped into the glove for strike three. What a pitching performance by Hamulak so far, just going right after the hitter. He is the closer, yes. Alama was effective. Hamulak was effective. Bo Vaughn had a bump in the road.
Third baseman number 19, Luis Lopez.
But Hamulak, one out away from getting his team a split of a series in which Bridgeport looked like they were going to go on the rampage in the eighth inning. They really looked like they wanted to come back. Two out tosses, outside one ball, no strikes, and had the hitting necessary to come back. In the end, the sacrifice from Paletsky may have done them in by giving up one out. Pitches outside, two balls, no strikes. He was all over the place, and they were giving Bo Vaughn a long leash because of his string of success. Two balls, no strikes. Quick conversation between Hernandez and Hamulak because he threw two down in the zone outside. It almost seems like catcher and manager will never allow these pitchers to really get in too uncomfortable of a spot. The 2-0 is right down the middle, 2-1. Perhaps talking about arm slot the way that they had discussed beforehand, that arm slot was slightly better. He let it go just in time for a strike. The 2-1. Another heater right down the middle. Lopez taking. The Bluefish down to the final strike. Hamulak has had his command in this day. And so has Lancaster. The 2-2 is upcoming. Glove up. Pitch. Sent foul to the netting. Lopez just missed it. He beside himself. He thought he should have kept it fair. Two balls, two strikes. If Lopez somehow gets on base, Angel Flores is waiting in the on-deck circle. The 2-2. A high chopper towards the middle. It's at second. Handling his boy. He throws on the move. It's in time as he beats Lopez by a stride. The ball game is over. The Bluefish fall by a score of 6-3 in the finale at the ballpark at Harbor Yard, the four-game series. They will continue the series on Tuesday night. We'll be back right after this with the post-game show right after this.
We
know there's only one thing baseball fans love as much as great Pilsner taste, and that's rooting for the home team. Because home is way better than away. Away is not where the heart is. Bringing away the bacon? Why? Bacon is delicious. Away is where you hang your hat? You should be hung up by your underpanties. So why root for the away team when you can root for the home team? With a great Pilsner taste of Miller Lite. Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Shark tooth, screwdriver, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on. Grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open the new Miller Lite Punch Top Can, but you'll always get the same thing. A smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. Shark tooth, screwdriver, skeleton key, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, the lucky fishing lure you snagged Alan with. Sorry, Alan. Drumsticks. Chopsticks from the place you met that Dallas-based flight attendant. A motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. A spark plug. A domino. A house key. How do these things make Miller Lite from a can even better? Find out May 2012. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Lite wants you to win the greatest weekend that never happened. The ultimate Vegas weekend for you and a buddy. Just collect Miller Lite taste points for your chance to win one of 100 Vegas trips being given away this summer for the big weekend. So grab Miller Lite and seize the summer at tastepoints.com. It's that easy, and it never happened. It's Miller time. No purchase necessary. Open to legal U.S. residents 21 or older. Void in California and where prohibited. Sweepstakes begins 5/1/12 and ends 8/1/12. For details, how to enter, and complete official rules, go to tastepoints.com. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Miller time. Don't check your wrist or follow up with your supervisor. Because Miller time has nothing to do with when and everything to do with who.
What's up, Tommy?
Miller Lite is brewed for the guys you're proud to call your brothers. Who'll always talk you out of getting that faux hawk. And never talk.
Nice.
During your backswing. And when you've got your brothers and the light beer that tastes like a beer should, it's not just a good time, it's Miller time.
Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
Shark tooth, screwdriver, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open the new Miller Lite Punch Top Can, but you'll always get the same thing. A smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together? Just like a good team. At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
This is Terry McGriff.
The Bluefish Broadcast Network continues with the post-game show on BridgeportBluefish.com. Perry Miles here. The final score is 6-3 A very simple scoring summary. E5 in the second inning allowed Ryan Harvey to reach for Lancaster, Brad Boyer, and Francisco Hernandez walked and singled respectively to load the bases. And with two men out, after a strikeout, Blake Galen delivers a grand slam. Those four runs unearned on Raymar Diaz's resume. Then in the eighth inning, shifts with a single, Terry Tiffey, Valon Lentini, a two-run shot to make it 6-0. The Bluefish would respond walk-walk single. And then with nobody out, a bases clearing double to left center field for James Simmons. Peter Barrows hit an infield single. Paletsky sacrificed. In the end, the Bluefish were not able to drive in the key run when they needed to. In the end, 6-3 the score. 6 runs, 7 hits, 3 runs, 8 base hits, and 1 error. Hit from Godwin, hit and run, and 4 ribbies from Galen. Hit and run from Tiffey, hit and run, and 2 ribbies from Lentini. Frostad and Pedroza each with 1 hit. Harvey and Boyer each with 1 run. Hernandez with a hit and a run on the day. Meanwhile, for the Bluefish, Ayala and Rogers with a hit. Nothing for Redmond. No hits for Peterson or Lopez, but each of them scored a run. Flores, 2 hits and a run. 3 hits for Simmons, 3 ribbies. Barrows with a hit, and Paletsky did not have anything on the day. 3 runs, 8 hits, 1 error. Simmons with his first double. Home run from Galen, his 10th. He now leads the Barnstormers. Lentini with his 6th. Galen, 4 RBI, he now has 29. Lentini with 2 has 25. Simmons with 3, he now has 7. Harvey was hit by a pitch his first. Paletsky with a sacrifice. Stolen bases, Godwin 2, he has 18 on the year. Ayala with 1 after he stole the base. And Luis Lopez with his 9th error, costing the Bluefish 4 runs today. Bridgeport had 11 runners left on base. Lancaster with 6. In the end, John Halama wins the game 5-3 on the year. 6-inning shutout baseball, 5 hits, 3 walks, 3 strikeouts. Jason Aquides, an inning, a walk, and a strikeout. Both on 2/3 of an inning. 3 runs, all earned, 3 hits, 2 walks, and a strikeout. Jeff Bennett, 1/3 of an inning. Tim Hamulak is 11th save, an inning, and a strikeout. Raymar Diaz picks up the loss. 1-6 on the year. 4 innings, 4 runs, no earned. 4 hits, 3 walks, 7 strikeouts with a home run allowed. Tarzi, 3 innings of shutout baseball. Strikeout on his resume. Peltzer, an inning. 3 hits, 2 runs, both earned. 3 strikeouts and a home run allowed. Zaleski, an inning on for the right-hander. Peltzer with a hit by pitch, or he hit a batter, his 2nd. Strikeouts on the day, 11 for Bridgeport and their pitching staff, 6 for Lancaster and its pitching staff. Godwin, Tiffey, Lentini, Frostad, Pedroza. The first 4 had 1. Pedroza with 2 strikeouts, Harvey with 1, Boyer with 2, Hernandez with 2. In the end, Ayala, Rogers, Redmond each with 1, Peterson 2, and Barrows 1. A combined 9 walks, 6 allowed by Lancaster staff and 3 by Bridgeport staff. Adam Godwin, Terry Tiffey, Brad Boyer each with 1, Ayala with 2, Peterson 1, Lopez 2, and Paletsky. Time of the game, 3 hours and 13 minutes. Attendance of more than 3,000, 31-19 at the ballpark at Harbor Yard on this Sunday afternoon. One that the Bluefish would like to forget because they had so many opportunities early in the game, they just did not score against Lama. In the end, the Bluefish fall by a score of 6-3. When we come back on the Bluefish postgame show, we will wrap it up from the ballpark at Harbor Yard with the Atlantic League scores and the Major League scores right after this.
If you're not choosing a light beer with more taste, you need to man up, not man down. Because up is way better than down. You don't tell someone sad to cheer down. What's down, dog? A steamy pile and you just stepped in it. Your girlfriend's not wearing a push-down bra. It's called gravity, Isaac Nitwit. Can I be down front with you? All this down talk is bringing me down. So don't man down, man up, and choose a light beer with more taste. Triple Hops Brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. At Miller Lite, we know there's only one thing baseball fans love as much as great Pilsner taste, and that's rooting for the home team. Because home is way better than away. Away is not where the heart is. Bringing away the bacon? Why? Bacon is delicious. Away is where you hang your hat? You should be hung up by your underpanties. So why root for the away team when you can root for the home team? With a great Pilsner taste of Miller Lite. Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Shark tooth, screwdriver, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle-nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open the new Miller Lite Punch Top Can, but you'll always get the same thing. A smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time.
Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
The post-game show continues from the ballpark at Harbor Yards. The kids continue to make their way around the bases, a slew of them making their way out to the ballpark at Harbor Yard for this afternoon's contest. The Bluefish, though, did fall by a score of 6-3. Let's take a look at the rest of the Atlantic League scoreboard, courtesy of PointStreet.com and AtlanticLeague.com, as we take a quick look at everything that has been unfolding, as there were a couple of final scores to report, and another game which has been reported final as well. Let's start off with the good news for the Bluefish, if there is one. The Southern Maryland Blue Crabs take down the Long Island Ducks to 8-3. It's a catch-22 because Southern Maryland makes up a game on Bridgeport relative to where Long Island is. Bridgeport remaining 7 games behind the Long Island Ducks heading into the next series. Meanwhile, the Camden River Sharks fell to the Sugar Land Skeeters. So Bridgeport, within a couple of games, if they continue to succeed, or if they, at least they're aiming to move forward, if they do wind up winning a few more games, they might be able to catch the River Sharks, eventually the Blue Crabs, in the standings. Let's take a look at the one other final score. The Somerset Patriots take down the York Revolution by a score of 3-2. ESPN.com for the latest scores and summaries from around the U.S. Open. And Tiger Woods is way behind. Tiger Woods, he needed a fast start, but he's just not been performing well. And Graham McDowell, Jim Furyk, they're set to tee off 1-under par going into the final round of the tournament. And many other players, many other golfers are already in there starting out. One of them was Tiger, but he is struggling during his holes, and you wonder if he'll be able to make up the ground. Meanwhile, in Major League Baseball, the Yankees take down the Nationals 4-1. They have won 9 consecutive games. The Reds defeat the Mets 3-1. Boston, Red Sox, Chicago Cubs taking place from Wrigley at 8 o'clock tonight, the ESPN game. Milwaukee and Minnesota knotted at 4 in the bottom of the 11th with a runner at 3rd. Kansas City 2, St. Louis 2 in the top of the 11th with the bases loaded. Texas 7 and Houston 1 in the bottom of the 7th. Bottom 7 from Anaheim. The Angels lead 1-0 against Arizona. San Diego leads Oakland 1-0, top of the 6th. The White Sox and Dodgers are scoreless in the top of the 6th. San Francisco 1, Seattle 1, top of the 5th. Much of the rest of the scores are finals, including Pittsburgh taking down Cleveland 9-5. Detroit shutting out Colorado 5-0. Toronto over Philadelphia 6-2. Baltimore shuts out Atlanta 2-0. Tampa Bay shuts out Miami 3-0. Plenty of shutouts today in Big League Baseball. In the College World Series, Florida State leads Stony Brook 1-0 in the middle of the 2nd. The loser of that game is eliminated. The winner of the game will take on the loser of the UCLA-Arizona matchup tonight from Omaha. Meanwhile, in the NBA, Oklahoma City-Miami tonight, 8 o'clock Eastern, for Game 3 of the NBA Finals. That taking place tonight on ABC. Thank you for tuning in to the Bluefish Broadcast Network today. Perry Miles here. For more information about Bluefish Baseball, you can go to the website bridgeportbluefish.com or send an email to perrym86@gmail.com for the latest. You can also follow me on Twitter, just me, P. Miles. Just me, P. Miles. 6-3 the score. Tuesday will feature a set of pitchers that both teams have seen in the past. It'll be Toby Stoner for the Bluefish, 1-7, against J.D. Durbin, 2-4. For the Barnstormers, righty versus righty. The Bluefish fall to 11-16 at home, 5-11 in the month of June, 22-28 overall, and 2-5 against Lancaster, both in the season series and at home this year against the Barnstormers. The final score, the Bluefish fall 6-3. Lancaster improves to 30-20, while Bridgeport falls to 22-28. The first pitch on Tuesday night from the lower Susquehanna Valley in Lancaster is set for 7 o'clock p.m., which means a 6:40 pregame show from Clipper Magazine Stadium in Lancaster, Pennsylvania. We mentioned about the matchups. We hope that you enjoy the rest of your weekend as we are about to sign off from the ballpark at Harbor Yard. One more time, the Bluefish fall to the Barnstormers 6-3. For Perry Miles, have a wonderful night. We will see you on Tuesday.